Now it's time for the Laredo Lemurs pregame show. Laredo Lemurs baseball is brought to you by Popeye's Chicken, AEP Texas, Armadillo Homes, Ascending Technologies, Ashley's Furniture of Laredo, Capital Care EMS, Chavarias Plumbing, Core Business Solutions, Driscoll Health Plan, Falcon International Bank, Family Chevrolet, Gold's Gym, Guerra Communications, HEB, iGadget Repair Center, Kaplan College, Laredo International Airport, Laredo Pony League, Laredo Sports Medicine, Mike's Paint Place, Pepsi, Pro Mega Signs, Southern Distributing, Southern Sanitation, Talk and Talk Wireless, TAMU Housing and Residence, Texas Farm Bureau, Texas Inflatables, Texas Outlaw Grill, Tokyo Garden, Total Termite Pest and Control, Uni-Trade 40, Whataburger of Alice. And now here's Bill Harrington with the Laredo Lemurs pregame show.
All right, Lemurs fans, thanks for joining us tonight. Bill Harrington along with you, coming to you live from Uni-Trade Stadium as the Lemurs get ready for a really big series here starting tonight. The Wichita Wingnuts are in town, and we got a big one for you. But first, we want to take a look back at yesterday's ball game for the Laredo Lemurs as they went on to get the victory. They took 2 out of 3 games against the Amarillo Thunderheads, and the Lemurs won yesterday by a final score of 7-4. It was 7 runs on 12 hits. They picked up 2 errors to the Lemurs. For Amarillo, they had 4 runs on 7 hits. They made 2 errors. Henry Garcia, he ended up getting the win for Laredo, and Clay Chapman ended up taking the loss. John Berbia picked up his 15th save on the year. And for the Lemurs, it all got started pretty early in the ballgame as they ended up seeing Ty Morrison reach on a single in the bottom of the first inning. Then the next two batters got out. Both Jeudy Valdez and Kevin Taylor hit the ball very hard to left field, but the left fielder Guida was able to make the catch on both of them. Dennis Phipps had an opportunity to come up to the plate. He would pick up a single, and then Devontre Richardson would show off his stuff at the plate. They roll through the American Association. Here's the 1-0. Swung in and a fly ball. Shallow center field, charging his Kerstad. The ball's going to fall. The Lemurs are going to go up 1-0. As Morrison comes across the plate and scores, and just a little dunk hit by Devontre Richardson puts the Lemurs up. Yeah, so Devontre Richardson coming up big for the Laredo Lemurs. That would make it 1-0 in favor of Laredo. Then Dustin Geiger, he'd be the next batter in the bottom of the first inning. He would help out as well. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Swung and a ground ball over to the right side. That's going to slip through the hole. Phipps is being waved home. Gartrell up at the ball. He drops the baseball, and Phipps is going to score for the Laredo Lemurs. Yeah, so a RBI single there for Dustin Geiger. He got on the board with the Laredo Lemurs. The Lemurs would score another run later on in the inning when Juan Silverio reached on an error, and that ended up bringing home Devontre Richardson from third base. So the Lemurs took a 3-0 lead into the first. We'd go to the top of the second, and the Thunderheads would get their lone run in the early part of the game. They would end up scoring a little bit later, but Stefan Gartrell reached on a double, and then Christian Ibarra ended up reaching on a single, and that would bring home Gartrell, and it would be a 3-1 ball game in favor of Laredo. So the Lemurs would come right back and get 3 more runs in the second inning. Here's how that went down. After Jared Madero struck out, Ty Morrison reached on an error. It was an error by the second baseman, Valentin. Then Jeudy Valdez had a chance to step up to the plate. Morrison runs. The pitch is swung on and grounded past the third baseman down the left field line. Morrison's around the bag at second. He's coming into third base. Gibby Velacuellar is going to send him home. Morrison will score standing. There will be no play there, and the Lemurs are up 4-1. And Jeudy Valdez with a double. Yeah, big double there for Jeudy Valdez. A nice hit for him. Kevin Taylor would be the next batter, and he would hit a deceptive home run. Kevin Taylor, it's the first pitch he sees. It goes back to the wall, and it ends up hitting off the top of the fence. And they're actually going to say it's a home run for Kevin Taylor. Yeah, wasn't quite sure if it was a home run or not right off of the bat. It ended up hitting the gold fence, which sits on top of the home run fence. So if the ball hits the gold fence, which is really tough for us to see here from this angle, if the ball hits the gold fence, it is a home run. We looked back at the video. That's exactly what happened. And the ball came bounding back into the field of play. So the umpires made the right call there. The Lemurs had 3 more runs up on the board, and they were up 6-1 as we moved on throughout the ball game. The Lemurs would put up another run in the sixth inning, a double by Ty Morrison, and then later Kevin Taylor would pick up another one of his 3 hits on the day. He would bring home Ty Morrison, and the Lemurs would go up 7-1 at that time. Well, the Thunderheads would make a threat there in the ninth inning. Ryan Beckman started the ninth inning for the, or actually scratched that, Willie Paredes started the ninth inning for the Lemurs. He couldn't get anybody out. In fact, he gave up 3 hits and 3 runs in the inning, Ryan Beckman came on. He gave up a base hit, and then the Lemurs turned it over to their closer, John Brebbia. Brebbia would close things down for the Lemurs like he's supposed to do, and he picked up his 15th save on the year. So Neil Dwyer was able to sit down with manager Pete Gavilla after last night's ball game, and this is what the manager had to say about last night's tilt. Bill Harrington, along with one of the starting pitchers.
Tying run came to the plate twice at ninth with the hearts palpitating a little in the dugout?
No, not really. I mean, stuff like that happens, but, that's the luxury we have is we got John Brebbia on the bullpen, and he's pretty good. So, things start to escalate pretty fast. Tried to get through without using John, but, that's his job, Came in and closed the game out for us. Pretty good ball game. Henry pitched terrific. Felt pretty good about taking him out of there. He's at right at 100 pitches and try and take care of him a little bit because he's got some really important starts coming up. And, Henry pitched a hell of a game. So that was a good win, and, we'll see what we can do tomorrow against Wichita.
Henry actually had the most run support all year, 7 runs. How dangerous can this team be with that kind of pitching and that kind of support?
Yeah, if we get any kind of run support, we're going to be dangerous. If we can go out and score runs early in games, we're going to be tough to deal with because our bullpen's been so good. I mean, I know Willie didn't do a very good job tonight. He'll be better because he's pretty good. And, Beckman gave up a knock. But, in that situation, I feel very comfortable, with the lead, bringing in our bullpen. I feel pretty good about our chances to win.
No, Taylor continues to be pretty hot, getting a home run and a couple more hits. So what do you think of what he's doing lately?
Hey, KT can hit, man. We've known this for a long time. He's a pretty special guy, and we're going to need him. Hopefully he's getting hot at the right time for us. Playing teams that we're chasing, and I feel like we're right in the thick of things.
I'm sorry.
So yeah, speaking of being right in the thick of things, what do you think about the big stretch with Wichita coming up?
Yeah, it's no different. I mean, you got to win every day, whether you're playing Wichita or playing somebody else. I mean, that's why they call it a pennant race. It doesn't really matter who you're playing, but I think it's bigger. Anytime you're playing somebody in a division that you're chasing, I mean, of course, I think our guys are going to be, ready to go and have a lot of energy and passion, playing Wichita. But whether you're playing Amarillo or Wichita, it doesn't matter. You got to win. Every day is really important.
It's Lucen's turn after Garcia in the rotation. Is he going tomorrow?
Yeah, Lucen's going tomorrow, yeah.
He's 0-1 versus Wichita this year. Have you and Mike been kind of working with him, really focusing and prepping him for this game against Wichita lately?
We feel like, Luce threw really well in Grand Prairie. I think his last two starts, we feel like he's throwing really well. We feel pretty good about Luce going up against Wichita. I mean, he's pitched as good as anybody in our rotation the last two times out. So we feel really good about Luce. I don't think we've done anything different to prepare him. We're just trying to get him mechanically correct and get him pointed in the right direction. I feel like his last two starts have been pretty good.
That's Lemurs manager Pete Gavilla along with Neil Dwyer and the beat writer for the Laredo Morning Times, Zach Davis. We're going to take a timeout on the other side of the break, though. I was able to sit down today with last night's starter, Henry Garcia. We talked to him, and that interview is coming up next. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Uni-Trade continues to provide solutions in foreign trade through a highly satisfactory customs brokerage service. Uni-Trade has quality trained personnel devoted to the highest level of customer service. For all your transportation, distribution, and consolidation needs, it's Uni-Trade. Chavarria's Plumbing's the number one choice for any plumbing problem. Chavarrias is a full-service company with up-to-date technology trained professionals. With over 30 years of service to the community, Chavarrias is still growing strong. Visit ChavarriasPlumbing.com and go Lemurs!
Core Business Solutions is a proud sponsor of Lemurs Baseball. Core Business Solutions services the 17 southernmost counties of Texas as well as areas of northern Mexico. They offer a wide range of high-tech solutions for businesses and organizations. Make Core Business Solutions your solution today. For all of your vehicle collision repair and paint needs, there's only one place to turn, Mike's Paint Place. Mike's Paint Place has computerized color matching and digital imaging. They also do full frame and suspension repairs. Stop by and see Mike's Paint Place today at 6410 Polaris Drive in Laredo. Hey fans, every Monday night at Uni-Trade Stadium is Margarita Monday. Come on out to the ballpark and cool off with an ice cold margarita for only $2. But please do not drink them too fast. You might get a brain freeze. To get tickets, call 956-7 Lemurs. Check us out at LaredoLemurs.com.
Bill Harrington along with one of the starting pitchers for the Laredo Lemurs, Henry Garcia. And Henry got the start in last night's ball game. Ended up picking up the win for the Laredo Lemurs. He went 8 strong innings, only gave up a run in the outing, gave up 3 hits, didn't walk anybody, and struck out 8. His overall record this season is 4 wins and 6 losses, a 3.01 ERA. 21 games he's pitched in, and so far he has made 11 starts for the Lemurs. And get this, Henry, I know this might be interesting to you yourself. Over your last 6 starts, you've only given up 6 runs, so pretty good outings for you as of late. How's it feel to be out there on the mound right there when you get the starts?
I'm just happy to have some quality starts right now. You know, I started off kind of rocky coming out of the bullpen. I'm just happy that things are falling into place. You know, and I have the defense behind me and I have run support.
Well, like you mentioned, you started off a little bit rocky coming out of the bullpen and going into the starting rotation. It seems like you were a little bit reluctant to get into the starting rotation. Is that true, or is that just making assumptions up from the broadcast booth?
Making assumptions. I've been wanting to start for a very long while now. Ever since I was with the Diamondbacks, because before that I was a starter, and I wanted to get back on the mound as a starter. But I didn't mind being in the bullpen too much. You know, being a lefty specialist, I like being back in the starting role. I have a routine that I can follow now, you know.
What has been the biggest difference for you moving from the bullpen into the rotation?
Focus, because when you're starting, I mean, you have to be focused the whole game. And when you're starting, I mean, when you're relieving, I mean, you only come in for an inning. You focus for like 3 batters and that's it, you know. Just focus is a big difference there.
What has been the biggest inspiration for you as a starter so far? I know Mike Myers worked a lot with you to get you where you are today. So talk a little bit about him and what kind of inspiration he's been for you so far this year.
You know, Mike, I like Mike a lot. He's a blessing in disguise. I couldn't imagine myself having another pitching coach other than him. I mean, he fell right in my lap, and he's a great inspirational person overall. You know, and he's here really to help us out. Develop us into the best we can be, and I mean he's an awesome coach. I can't ask more out of him. I mean, he's devotes his time to us, really.
I can see it's a little bit tough for you to talk about yourself. Let's talk about some of the guys around you. Some of the guys in the starting rotation for the Laredo Lemurs. You got Matt Lewis and Luis Poyorena. Talk a little bit about those guys and how they've helped you out so far this year.
We help each other out. I mean, it's a team sport. You know, we're there for each other. We push each other. Even when we're down, we pick them up. You know, Luis, I've known him since high school. We play against each other in the playoffs when we were in high school. Lucin, played with him in the fall league.
In the Arizona Diamondbacks organization, let's talk a little bit about that experience. Was it a fun experience for you? Was it pretty neat to being able to play in the Cal League?
The Cal League was kind of, I mean, it was fun. Overall, a great experience, but the Cal League was kind of brutal. I mean, it's a hitter's league. The batting averages for everyone, they're inflated. Pitchers' ERAs are way up, you know. But, I mean, it's fun. It was a great experience being with the Diamondbacks. I'll never forget it. I mean, I'm trying to get back to organization baseball, but with the Diamondbacks, they always have a special place in my heart.
So you're working here in independent baseball. What do you think it's going to take for you to get yourself back into affiliated ball?
Just consistency to just continue throwing up good numbers. I mean, I think that's the key to get out of here, just being able to be consistent with it, being able to throw strikes, run your off-speed pitches for strikes, just being consistent.
Real quick, so what is your prediction for the rest of the season for the team itself? I mean, you guys, you know, you've had a little bit of an up and down season, playing a little bit over .500, but the team seems to be gelling down the stretch. What do you think is going to end up happening here towards the end of the year?
You know what? I think we're going to make a stretch for the playoffs. I think we're going to make the playoffs. I have faith in my teammates. You know, the coaching staff is amazing. I think we're gonna be there. I think we're gonna be in it.
That's Henry Garcia. I'm Bill Harrington. We'll be right back right after this.
Time came to play twice.
Hey Lemurs fans, every Thursday night at Uni-Trade Stadium is a Thirsty Thursday. Come on out and enjoy cold Miller Lite draft beers for only $1. That's right, beer for a buck. You can get tickets online at laredolemurs.com or by phone at 956-7-LEMURS. I'll see you at the ballpark.
Right now, when you sign up for a Gold's Gym membership, you'll get tons of extras completely free. Confidence, free. Compliments from your coworkers, free. and the desire to wear tiny bathing suits, you guessed it, free. You'll be stronger with extras, and you'll be stronger with Gold's Gym. Know your own strength. Tiny bathing suit not included.
Pro Mega Signs of Laredo is there for all of your printing and signage needs. We can be found at 1615 Jackman Road in Laredo, or you can reach us by phone at 956-723-2110. Again, that's 956-723-2110. If you need a sign, big or small, come to Pro Mega Signs of Laredo, where your print job is just around the corner.
In over 40 years, nobody's helped more families achieve the American dream of home ownership than Armadillo. In fact, Armadillo Homes has built more homes than all other builders combined. And there are reasons for this. Integrity, responsibility, service, and of course, quality. So if you're thinking about making the greatest investment in your life, think of the one builder who's dedicated its entire life to helping the Laredo family. Think Armadillo Homes, armadillohomes.com. Go Lemurs.
We all know we can accomplish more when we're ready. That's why I've chosen Texas A&M International University. I want a four-year degree and the opportunities that it brings. TAMU has welcomed me and more than 7,000 students from around the world. TAMU empowers me to greatness, ignites my mind, and propels me to my future and my impact. Imagine the possibilities when you're powered by TAMU.
Register now for summer and fall. Visit TAMU.edu and get powered.
All right, just about ready for the national anthem here at Uni-Trade Stadium. We'll go ahead and go over the pitching matchups for tonight's ballgame. For the Laredo Lemurs, Matt Lucen's going to be taking the hill. He's going to be going to the mound with a record of 4 wins and 5 losses. He has a 3.78 ERA, and he's going to be making his 17th start tonight for the Laredo Lemurs. Tim Brown's going to be going to the hill for Wichita. He's got a record of 8 wins and 2 losses, and he's got a 3.64 ERA through 15 starts so far this season. Of course, we'll talk more about those guys throughout the ballgame here tonight. And I think we're ready for the national anthem here at the ballpark as we'll turn it over to the public address announcer. First pitch coming your way next.
Laredo Lemurs Baseball is on the air, brought to you by Popeye's Chicken, AEP Texas, Armadillo Homes, Ascending Technologies, Ashley's Furniture of Laredo, Capital Care EMS, Chavarias Plumbing, Core Business Solutions, Driscoll Health Plan, Falcon International Bank, Family Chevrolet, Gold's Gym, Getter Communications, HEB, iGadget Repair Center, Kaplan College, Laredo International Airport, Laredo Pony League, Laredo Sports Medicine, Mike's Paint Place, Pepsi, Pro Mega Signs, Southern Distributing, Southern Sanitation, Talk and Talk Wireless, TAMU Housing and Residence, Texas Farm Bureau, Texas Inflatables, Texas Outlaw Grill, Tokyo Garden, Total Termite Pest and Control, Uni-Trade 40, Water River of Alice. And now here's Bill Harrington with all your Laredo Lemurs play-by-play action.
All right, Lemurs fans, welcome into the ballpark. Bill Harrington along with you tonight here at Uni-Trade Stadium. It's game one of a very important three-game series as the Laredo Lemurs welcome in the Wichita Wingnuts. Let's go ahead and get you the starting lineups for tonight's game for Wichita. They're going to be leading off with Jace Ray. He's going to be playing out in center field. David Espinoza is going to bat second. He'll work as the DH tonight. TJ Mittelstadt's going to bat in the three spot. He'll play out in right field. Andy LaRoche, former major leaguer, going to be playing third base and batting fourth. Matt Padgett, the first baseman, he'll bat in the five spot. John Nestor's going to be doing the catching. He'll bat sixth. Harrison Kane's the left fielder. He'll bat in the seven hole. Taylor Smart's playing shortstop. He'll bat eighth. And Leo Vargas, he'll bat in the ninth spot and play second base. We're just about ready to go here from Uni-Trade Stadium on a beautiful Friday evening. Wichita tonight, they're wearing their red tops with white numbers and letters. They have gray pants on. The Lemurs wearing their all-white uniforms today. They got the double L on the left side of their chest. I'll give you the defensive starting lineup here for the Lemurs in just a second. We'll also get the umpires here as well. Matt Lucen up on the hill. He's ready to go. Jace Ray into the batter's box. He's also ready to go. Here comes the pitch. And it is a little bit high. We're underway. 7:37 is your game time. Your game time temperature is a nice hot 99 degrees here in Laredo, Texas. So one ball and no strikes. Here's the delivery. That one is a strike on the outside corner just below the letters where it says nuts across the chest. Yeah, it says N-U-T-S right across the chest of the Wichita Wingnuts uniforms. Jace Ray wears number 4. Lucen works quickly, and he'll throw home. He dots the I right there on the outside part of the plate and gets the strike. One ball, two strikes. Just underway here at Uni-Trade Stadium this evening. David Espinoza on deck. He'll be followed up by TJ Mittelstadt. So Ray out of the batter's box. He took a little bit of a breather there. He's batting 306 on the year right now, is Jace Ray. The 1-2 pitch swung on and lofted foul over to the left. So here's the defense for you. A little bit of a change on the defensive side for the Lemurs tonight. Ty Morrison's actually playing left field this evening. We've seen him in center field since he's joined the Lemurs club. Devontre Richardson's been moved back into center field for most of the season. He was the center fielder until Ty Morrison showed up. The 1-2 pitch, breaking ball, topped off the top of the plate, and it's going to roll foul. Dennis Phipps in a normal spot. He's out and right. Silverio playing his bag at third. Ty Forney's playing shortstop tonight. Kevin Taylor's at the bag at second. And Dustin Geiger over there in first base. And getting his first start behind the plate tonight for the Laredo Lemurs is Phil Pohl. Pohl spelled P-O-H-L, by the way. Not P-O-L-E or P-O-L-L. The 1-2 pitch, it's in the dirt, blocked by Pohl. So that's going to even up the count at 2 balls and 2 strikes. Your umpires tonight, Matt Herrera behind the plate. Michael Campbell, he's over at first base. And Mike Jarbo, he's over at third tonight. So the same crew that was just in here for Amarillo is in here tonight for the Wichita series as well. Here's the 2-2 pitch. That's low and outside. 3 balls and 2 strikes now to Jace Ray. Well, Lemurs do not need to be walking these guys. The Wichita Wingnuts are very good at taking a walk. They have 325 walks on the year. They haven't even played 100 games yet. Here comes the pitch. Breaking ball swung on and fouled away. Yeah, they've walked 325 times. The next closest team is St. Paul with 282 walks, a difference of 43 walks. So these guys will indeed take a walk. They have no issue with that. And Matt Lucen is the guy that's actually on top of the Laredo Lemur starting rotation and giving up walks. Lucen, so far this year, he's fourth in the league in the category. He's given up 45 walks on the year through his time on the mound, 76 and a third innings. He throws low here, and that's going to be ball 4. So there's another walk in the books for the Wichita Wingnuts. So Matt Lucen's really got to make sure he throws strikes today because these guys, the Wichita Wingnuts, have very good eyes up there at the plate. By the way, Lucen starting the day with a record of 3 wins and 5 losses. He's sporting a 4.12 ERA through 15 starts this year for Laredo. So he's making his 16th start here tonight. He last started on August 4th against Sioux Falls. He went 6 complete, gave up 3 runs. Only 1 was earned, and he gave up 10 hits. He did not get a decision, though, in the ballgame. No score and a runner at first base. The runner goes immediately. The pitch is in there for a strike. The throw down to second base is going to be a little tardy for the party. And that's a stolen base for Jace Ray. So immediately they test Phil Pohl out and see what he's got. And Jace Ray is off to the races. Ray, by the way, he can steal a bag or two. That's going to be his 14th of the season right there. So in the batter's box right now, David Espinoza. Well, they put 1 ball and no strikes up on the board. I believe they called that a strike. We'll have to wait and see. Espinoza tries to lay down a bunt. It goes up the third baseline, foul. So that makes it one ball and one strike, according to the scoreboard. But I thought that was called a strike on the pitch where Jace Ray tried to take off for second base. So it's 0-2. The umpire just pointed up here and did say it was no balls and two strikes. So a runner at second base, an 0-2 count, and nobody out. Lucen from the stretch. He deals home. That one is low for a ball. Yeah, these Wichita Wingnuts, they're also very good at stealing bases. They have stole 89 as a team so far this year. So their manager, Kevin Hooper, likes to put the guys in motion. So the Lemurs really got to be weary of that. Got to make sure they keep these guys from running as much as possible. Of course, if Full Pole has a good arm back there, we'll have to find out. Throughout this series, the 1-2 pitch is fouled away. So that'll keep the count at one ball and two strikes. Of course, we could just look up Phil Pohl's numbers behind the plate throughout his time throughout minor league baseball. Kind of give you an idea where he sits throwing guys out. So here's his defensive numbers throughout his career. He's thrown out 21% of would-be base stealers. So they like to see him at 30%. That's usually the average that they're looking for. The 1-2 pitch, a breaking ball in the dirt blocked by Pohl. So far, he's done a good job doing that, keeping the ball out in front of them. That's really a big deal back there. If you can keep the ball out in front of you, they'll let you get away with not throwing out as many guys behind the plate. Got to make sure you keep those guys from getting free bases on the wild pitches and pass balls. So yeah, but Phil Pohl, throughout his professional career, has thrown out 21% of would-be base stealers. Here's the 2-2. Swung on and a chopper over to the second baseman. Taylor grabs it on the second hop. He'll throw over to first base for the out. Espinoza's retired, and there's one out. And T.J. Mittelstadt, he'll be the next batter coming up to the plate. So Mittelstadt will get a chance. Mittelstadt tonight playing out in right field. He's listed as an infielder on the roster for the Wichita Wingnuts. No score in the game, but a runner at third base and one out now for Wichita. Wichita starting off in first place in the American Association South Division as we get started today. The Lemurs sit five games out of first place, so a big series here for Laredo. The infield's going to play in for the Lemurs. Here's the pitch. It's a little bit low. One ball and no strikes. Mittelstadt, by the way, he's batting 257. He's got 11 home runs and 50 RBIs on the year. The Joplin Blasters sit behind Wichita. They're four games back. Here's the pitch, a breaking ball. That hits the inside, the outside corner of the plate. So an even count of one ball and one strike to T.J. Mittelstadt. Lucen here, probably pitching for the strikeout. You either want the strikeout or a pop-up on the infield, maybe even a ground ball to one of those infielders that are playing in. The 1-1 pitch. That's a strike on the outside part of the plate. A fastball there. Good pitch there from Matt Lucen. But the strikeout would be the best thing to get in this situation. That way there's no ball put into play, and you don't have to worry if it goes to the outfield or not. That way you try to keep that run, Jace Ray, off of the board. One ball and two strikes. Lucen fires away, and it's a curveball swung on and fouled off. Mittelstadt hit the very top of that ball and went bounding over by the Lemurs on deck circle over on the first base side here at Uni-Trade Stadium. Just a slight breeze blowing, but I looked at the forecast and it said it might get up to 15 miles an hour tonight. Right now it's blowing out towards left field as it usually does here at the ballpark. And the 1-2 delivery. And that's a fastball that's a little bit inside. So that makes it a 2-2 count. Pretty close pitch there, but the Lemurs don't get the call. Of course, we set up the third baseline, so it's a little bit tougher for us to tell the corner pitches. Two balls and two strikes. And the pitch. Breaking ball in the dirt. Dug out there by Phil Pohl. And that's going to make the count full. Three balls and two strikes. So once again, Matt Lucen in a situation where he might end up walking a batter. Mittelstadt up there at the plate. He has 70 walks on the season. That actually leads the team. So he's one of the big culprits at the plate. 70 walks is amazing. The 3-2 pitch swung on and missed. It gets away from Pohl. It rolls up the third baseline. Pohl has to throw over to first base to complete the out. The Lemurs get the out there. And that keeps the runner at third base. So the Lemurs get the strikeout that they're looking for. And it was a nasty pitch that just broke down into the dirt. And T.J. Mittelstadt couldn't lay off of it. And a nice job there by Phil Pohl to, you know, let it hit off of his chest. Unfortunately, it banged off and went over to his left, and he had to run it down. But that ball running up the third baseline helped Jace Ray have to get back to third base. So in a sense, it kind of helped out, but it was a close play at first. Here comes Mike Meyer out of the dugout. He wants to talk things over with Matt Lucen. The Lemurs are an out away from getting out of the inning. And they would love to have that momentum going back into the dugout. You know, Jace Ray, very big baseball player for this Wichita Wingnuts club. He sets the tone quite a bit. In fact, he has scored 44 times this year. And that is the second most on the team. Two guys are tied with 51 runs. Well, TJ Mittelstadt and David Espinoza, they've both scored 50-run runs so far this year for Wichita. So, in a sense, Ray is in third place. But those two guys tied for first. So Phipps and Richardson out in center field and right field, they got together between that conversation. I wonder what they had to talk about. That's kind of an oddity. Usually don't see those two guys come together, or any outfielders come together, just from a conversation on the mound. Here's the pitch to Adam LaRoche, a former major leaguer, stepping into the batter's box. Excuse me, Andy LaRoche. I said his brother's name, Adam LaRoche. Just kind of a natural. Kind of just rolls right off the tongue. Well, Andy batting 273. He's only playing in his fourth game for Wichita, and he takes a strike here on the inside corner. Yeah, so far, he's got a 273 average. He's 3 for 11. He has a double and 4 RBIs. So a former big leaguer here playing baseball today. And the 1-1 pitch. Breaking ball swung on and nubbed up the right side. That actually goes over by the first base coaching box and had a lot of spin to it. So Andy LaRoche actually went to spring training with the White Sox this year. And then the Wichita Wingnuts, their staff saw him playing in the NBC, the National Baseball Congress. And they approached him to play for the Wingnuts, of all things. I mean, for all things, he was playing in the NBC, which is amazing in itself. This guy was just recently in the big leagues, as late as 2013. Here's the 1-2. And that one's backhanded by Pohl as they had to move over to his right to make the catch. Runner at third base and two down. No score in the ballgame. Yeah, Andy LaRoche spent a total of 404 big league games over 6 years. Played with the Dodgers, the Pirates, and the Oakland A's, also the Toronto Blue Jays. The 2-2 pitch, a curveball swung on, grounded over to the left side. Silverio's up with it. He'll do the 360 spin. He'll throw it to first base. Geiger with the stretch on the other side, and that'll do it for the Wingnuts. So the Lemurs help the Wingnuts leave a runner stranded over there at third base, and a nice job there by Matt Lucen after walking Jace Ray. We're going to the bottom of the first inning. Lemurs coming up to the plate. We have no score.
Falcon Bank and the Laredo Lemurs are a winning combination. At Falcon, they know what counts. Personalized service, attention to detail, and genuine commitment to helping customers achieve their dreams. Falcon Bank, guided by faith, grounded by family, and committed to you.
Need a little spark in your life?
Then come on out to Uni-Trade Stadium for Friday Night Fireworks. Tickets start as low as $5, and you'll get to see great baseball and great fireworks all in one night. To get tickets, call 956-7-LEMURS or go online at laredolemurs.com. I'll see you at the ballpark. Hey, Lemurs fans, every Thursday night at Uni-Trade Stadium is a Thirsty Thursday. Come on out and enjoy cold Miller Lite draft beers for only $1. That's right, beer for a buck. You can get tickets online at laredolemurs.com or by phone at 956-7-LEMURS. I'll see you at the ballpark.
Uni-Trade continues to provide solutions in foreign trade through a highly satisfactory customs brokerage service. Uni-Trade has quality trained personnel devoted to the highest level of customer service. For all your transportation, distribution, and consolidation needs, it's Uni-Trade. Chavarrias Plumbing's the number one choice for any plumbing problem. Chavarrias is a full-service company with up-to-date technology trained professionals. With over 30 years of service to the community, Chavarrias is still growing strong. Visit chavarriasplumbing.com. And go Lemurs!
Core Business Solutions is a proud sponsor of Lemurs Baseball. Core Business Solutions services the 17 southernmost counties of Texas, as well as areas of northern Mexico. They offer a wide range of high-tech solutions for businesses and organizations. Make Core Business Solutions your solution today. For all of...
All right, back to action here at Uni-Trade Stadium. Let's go and get you the starting lineup for the Lemurs. Ty Morrison's leading off tonight, playing out in left field. J.U.D. Valdez will work as the designated hitter. He'll bat second. Kevin Taylor's batting in the three hole tonight. He'll play second base. Dennis Phipps batting in the four spot, playing right field. Devontre Richardson's playing out left tonight. He'll bat in the five spot. Batting sixth is Dustin Geiger, playing first base. Phil Pohl batting in the seven hole, doing the catching. Juan Silverio will play third base and bat eighth. And Ty Forney, the shortstop, he'll bat ninth. Here's the first pitch from Tim Brown. It's in there for a strike to Morrison. We're underway in the bottom of the first inning. No score in the game. And a tough customer, Tim Brown, up on the mound tonight. He throws another pitch. It's chopped up the middle. That's going to sneak through for a base hit. Ty Morrison aggressively around first base. And the Lemurs have a leadoff man on. Ty Morrison with a single. Look at Ty Morrison go. Such a fun brawl player to watch. He's been a great addition to the Lemurs club. You know, this Lemurs club just scattered with guys that really belong in affiliated baseball, and the Lemurs lucky to have them. Ty Morrison, one of those guys, and there'll be other guys, I'm sure, that will be picked up in the offseason. We're pretty much running out of time for guys to get picked up here towards the end of the season. You know, affiliated minor league baseball also gets done around the same time the Lemurs do. Here's the first pitch to Jeudy Valdez. It's taken high for a ball. So usually, once we get past the midway point in August, we don't see too many guys picked up by affiliated teams. But as soon as the season comes to an end, then we'll start seeing guys getting picked up off of the wires from the American Association, the Atlantic League, the Frontier League. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Jeudy Valdez shows bunt, and he fouls the ball off with the bunt attempt. So one ball and one strike. No score. Bottom of the first inning. Ty Morrison, by the way, with that hit right there, he picked up his 48th hit of the season. So he's a threat to go on the base paths. He's got 11 stolen bases on the year, but you want to be careful. The guy behind the plate, he's got a gun. John Nestor can throw out some guys trying to steal bags. Probably the best in the league. One ball and one strike. And Tim Brown working out of the stretch. He sets very low, and Morrison does run. The pitch is high. The throw down to second base is right on the money. And that is an out. Well, I warned you. So a 2-4 put out there. And the Lemurs have one out up on the board. Jeudy Valdez coming up. Or is up at the plate. He's looking at a 2-1 count. And Nestor is lean and mean behind the plate. And he's got one heck of an arm. So the Lemurs tempt fate there to see if they can get away with one, and they aren't able to. Valdez takes a strike on the outside corner, a fastball. Yeah, I'll take a look here, and I know Nestor's numbers are just silly, but I'll run them down for you real fast with him behind the plate. He is thrown out now, 23 of 50, as there's a ground ball off the bat of Jeudy Valdez over to the shortstop, Taylor Smart. Smart will fire away over to first base, and that's going to be in time to get the out. So a 6-3 put out, makes the second out of the inning. Yeah, get this. Nestor is throwing out 44% of base runners, and with that one right there, it's going to go up a little bit. So he's now 23 of 51 on attempted base stealers this year, and that's pretty silly. It's a really good average. Like I said earlier when we were talking about Phil Pohl, he'd be happy if he could throw out 30% of the base runners out there on the base paths, but Nestor is throwing out 44%. Here's the next batter, Kevin Taylor, the hot Kevin Taylor, I should say. He takes the first pitch outside. No score in the ball game. Bottom of the first inning, a big series here for the Lemurs, and Taylor looks at the next pitch. That's on the outside corner for a strike. Taylor is hitting 13 straight ball games for the Lemurs right now. He's batting .500 during that span. One ball and one strike. And Tim Brown fires away. That is low for a ball. Yeah, so Kevin Taylor through 13 games. He's 24 for 48. He's got 5 doubles, 3 homers, and 9 runs scored. He also has 12 RBIs. The 2-1 swung on and chopped over to the second baseman. Vargas is there. He'll take a couple shuffle steps and throw over to first base. And that'll do it for Taylor. That does it for the Lemurs. They get no runs on a hit, no errors, and nobody left. We're going to the second inning. No score here. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Tokyo Garden of Laredo is located at 2515 East Del Mar Boulevard, and they serve the best sushi in town. Stop by Tokyo Garden for a quick lunch or a fancy dinner. Either way, you're going to enjoy our fine cuisine. Did you just get off work? Then come on by and check out our happy hour specials. Tokyo Garden, where you'll find the best sushi in Laredo.
Right now, when you sign up for a Gold's Gym membership, you'll get tons of extras completely free. Confidence, free. Compliments from your coworkers, free. And the desire to wear tiny bathing suits, you guessed it, free. You'll be stronger with extras, and you'll be stronger with Gold's Gym. Know your own strength. Tiny bathing suit not included.
Pro Mega Signs of Laredo is there for all of your printing and signage needs. We can be found at 1615 Jackman Road in Laredo, or you can reach us by phone at 956-723-2110. Again, that's 956-723-2110. If you need a sign, big or small, come to Pro Mega Signs of Laredo, where your print job is just around the corner.
In over 40 years, nobody's helped more families achieve the American dream of home ownership than Armadillo. In fact, Armadillo Homes has built more homes than all other builders combined.
And there are reasons for this. Integrity, responsibility, service, and of course, quality. So if you're thinking about making the greatest investment in your life, think of the one builder who's dedicated its entire life to helping the Laredo family. Think Armadillo Homes, armadillohomes.com. Go Lemurs.
We all know we can accomplish more when we're ready. That's why I've chosen Texas A&M International University. I want a four-year degree and the opportunities that it brings. TAMU has welcomed me and more than 7,000 students from around the world. TAMU empowers me to greatness, ignites my mind, and propels me to my future and my impact. Imagine the possibilities when you're powered by TAMU.
Register now for summer and fall. Visit TAMU.edu and get powered.
All right, here we go into the top of the second inning. No score in the ball game. It's going to be Matt Padgett, John Nestor, and then Harrison Kane coming up to the plate for Wichita. The Lemurs have a hit up on the board. The Wichita Wingnuts did get a base runner in the first inning. Jace Ray earned a walk, ended up on third base. He actually got over to third base with one out, and the Wichita Wingnuts were not able to bring him home. So Padgett getting into the batter's box from the left side as always. He's got a nice compact swing as he takes that one low for a ball. Padgett into that compact stance, and a compact swing is the result. Here's the 1-0 pitch. That one is inside. That buzzes Padgett by his elbow. Padgett spent a little bit of time with the Lemurs earlier this year. Right now he's batting 229 through 65 games with Wichita. Padgett was actually with the Lemurs in spring training. The 2-0 pitch swung and missed. Then he played about 10 games with Laredo, and the Lemurs traded him over to the Wichita Wingnuts for Omar Benquomo. Two balls and a strike to Padgett. Padgett batting that 229. He's got 56 hits and 245 at-bats. And the 2-1 pitch. Low and away. A fastball there from Lucen. Padgett on the year. He's got 5 home runs since joining Wichita. And 2 of those home runs have come against the Lemurs this year. Both of them up in Wichita. Here comes the 3-1 pitch. Swung and a fly ball into left field. Ranging for the ball is the left fielder Morrison, and Morrison will watch it go out of play. So now a full count to Matt Padgett. Yeah, Padgett this year against Laredo. He's 10 for 38. He's got a .263 batting average, so that's above what his regular batting average is throughout the year. So he's hitting a little bit better against the Lemurs than he does throughout the whole season. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Loose and shaken off a couple of times. Now he decides on a pitch. Here it comes. Curveball in the dirt. And that'll be ball 4 for Padgett. So another walk delivered there by Matt Loosen. 1 in each inning so far. And that's a leadoff walk. So both innings, the first and the second, start off with leadoff walks. So Padgett heading over to first base. That is his 30th walk of the season. I told you in the first inning that this team leads the league in walks. 327 walks now on the year. It's pretty ridiculous for this club. So Nestor swings at the first pitch. He pops it up. Shallow left field. Morrison coming in, and he'll get underneath and encamp and make the easy catch. So one down, and Harrison Kane, the next batter. A familiar face around Unitrade Stadium, Harrison Kane, a former Lemur. Kane played with the Lemurs in 2013 and 2014. Always good to see Harrison Kane back at Unitrade Stadium. Earlier this year, he's playing with the Sioux Falls Canaries. So now he's playing with the Wichita Wingnuts, and through 22 games, he's batting a mighty .313. Runner at first base and one out. No score. Here's the pitch. Fastball misses low. Yeah, Kane with that .313 average. He's got 25 hits and 80 at-bats. He's picked up 6 doubles and 8 RBIs. And he has walked only 3 times. He's been hit by a pitch once. 1 ball, no strikes. And the delivery. A fastball on the outside edge. And that one goes right below the letters to Harrison Kane. So 1 ball and 1 strike. So the Wingnuts, by the way, with those walks, they're averaging 4-plus walks a game. Harrison Kane fouls off the breaking ball. That's going to make it a count of 1 ball and 2 strikes to Kane. I'm just going to go out on a limb here without knowing the Lemur's exact number, but I'm going to say the Lemur's probably average 2 walks per game. I know they don't walk a whole lot. They like to swing the bat. 1 ball and 2 strikes. At the beginning of the year, the Lemurs did walk a lot, but it's been shrinking. The 1-2 pitch misses away. So that makes it a count of 2 balls and 2 strikes. So Kane all the way in the very back of the batter's box. His back leg is on the back line, or his back foot is on the back line. And the deal by Luce, and a curveball swung on and popped up over to the right side. That's going to get into the stands. Well, Matt Luce throwing a plethora of curveballs here tonight. We saw Henry Garcia last night throw up a lot of curveballs. So I'm wondering if Luce says, well, it worked well for Garcia last night. Let me go ahead and try it here tonight. And I tell you what, if you can make it work, if you can make the ball dance and make it work for yourself, then you can do well. Here's the 2-2. That's low for a ball, and Phil Pohl moving over to his left. Yeah, the Lemurs this year in the walk category, they have walked 260 times. So 3 balls and 2 strikes to Kane. And we told you about Lucen. He's currently fourth in the league in giving up walks. He's already walked 2 batters here today, and he doesn't want to walk Harrison Kane to put Matt Pagen in scoring position. Here's the 3-2. A fastball swung on, belted well to left field. Going back on the ball, Morrison. He's going to leap, and the ball is gone. A home run for Harrison Kane. His first in a Wingnuts uniform. So he'll round the bases, and that scores 2 runs for the Wichita Wingnuts, and they take that early 2-0 lead, and that's the problem with falling behind. You get behind 3 balls and 2 strikes. Harrison Kane knew that Matt Luce had to come in with the strike, so you know he was geared up for fastball, and that's what he got, and he deposited it over the left field wall. So Kane turns on that one and helps his team out, and it's now 2-0 in favor of the Wichita Wingnuts. Matt Pagen was at first base on the play. And the next batter up is Taylor Smart. Well, Taylor Smart, a familiar name, but not with the Wichita Wingnuts. Taylor Smart, earlier this year, was with the Amarillo Thunderheads. Now, he wasn't with the team over the last 2 series with Amarillo. Here's the 0-1, swung on and a soft liner to the shortstop. Ty Forney, he'll backhand that one as he moves over to his right. Now to create the second out, Leo Vargas is going to be the next batter. By the way, Taylor Smart only playing in his sixth game. He's played 5 so far with Wichita. Yeah, so he ended up getting released from the Amarillo Thunderheads. And the Wichita Wingnuts were indeed in need of an infielder, so they were able to pick him up. He's got a really smooth glove. Doesn't hit all that well, but he's got a good mitt. As the next batter into the batter's box, Leo Vargas takes the first pitch low. 2-0, Wichita. Working underneath some clear skies tonight here at the ballpark. Pretty lovely day in Laredo, Texas, if you like it hot. The 1-0. That one is inside. 2 balls and no strikes. Good crowd on hand here this evening. Everybody, a lot of people, I should say, still filing into the ballpark. 2 balls, no strikes to Vargas. And the pitch. It's in the dirt. Now Phil Pohl's going to get out of his crouch and go have a conversation with Matt Luson. So they'll get together real quick and talk about things. Vargas, by the way, threw 33 games with Wichita. He's batting 195. He's got 16 hits and 82 at-bats. He's picked up a couple of doubles, and he has 4 RBIs, so he hasn't been too productive at the plate as far as driving guys in. But he does get on base from time to time. Leo Vargas working as the second baseman today. Here comes the 3-0 pitch from Luson. A fastball misses low. Third walk of the night given up by Luson. 2 outs here, and we're going to go up to the top of the order for Jace Ray. So Jace Ray getting into the batter's box. Jace Ray bats from the left side full time. He was born in Sonoma, California. Actually still lives in that area in Sonoma. Played last year a little bit in the Pacific Association with the Sonoma team. Here's a toss over to first base, and diving back in head first is Leo Vargas. So Vargas back in safely. And he's a threat to run. He's got 5 stolen bases on the year. Another toss to first, and this one a little bit harder throw by Matt Luson. But he gets back in once again safely. 2-0 Wichita. A 2-run home run by the former Lemur Harrison Kane. Well, Vargas over there with a pretty good sized lead. No wonder Lucen's throwing over there. He'll throw over again, and once again, another tag. That's a little tardy. Another guy that can steal a bag. He's in the batter's box right now. Jace Ray on the year with 13 stolen bases. He actually leads the Wingnuts team. Here's the pitch. Swung and a hot shot into right field. A base hit. That one hugged the ground all the way through, but it was hit very well off the bat of Jace Ray. So a base hit. And David Espinoza coming up to the plate. It's going to be the second hit in the ballgame for Wichita, one of them being that home run. So David Espinoza, the batter. Espinoza, he's a switch hitter, so he'll bat from the left side. Espinoza, one of two switch hitters on the team for the Wichita Wingnuts. Corey Mello, also a switch hitter. So runners at first and second base, and two outs. A 2-0 lead for the Wingnuts. Here's the first pitch, a curveball. That one dances on the outside corner for a strike. So no balls and a strike to David Espinoza, former member of the Kansas City T-Bones. Espinoza currently second in the league in walks. He's got 64 of those, so he's also a big guy in the walks category. Here's the 0-1. Fastball swung on and missed. So a good curveball to start it off by Luce, and then he comes back with the hummer of a fastball. Gets it in there for a strike, and it's no balls and two strikes. And David Espinoza last year was the 2014 American Association South Division All-Star. He was with Kansas City through most of the season last year and then got traded over to Wichita towards the end of the year. The curveball swung on and missed. That's strike three, and that's going to do it for Wichita, but they strike here in the second inning. A two-run home run by Harrison Kane. It's 2-0. Wingnuts, we're going to go to the bottom of the second inning. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Since Accepting Technologies opened for business in 1998, they have worked to establish solid relationships with their clients. They are set to maintain the highest standards of service and integrity and to perform work of only the highest quality, achieving client satisfaction on every project. They have attained these goals through a tradition of care and professional pride. They serve a wide range of corporations and small business franchises. Accepting Technologies has the tools and expertise for any technical need that your business may have. Call us here in Laredo at 725-2654. That's 725-2654 for Ascending Technologies.
Todos sabemos que podemos lograr más cuando estamos listos. Por eso, decidí matricularme en Texas A&M International University. Quiero un título universitario y las oportunidades que me brindará. TAMIU me ha recibido a mí y a 7,000 estudiantes de todo el mundo. TAMIU me impulsa a ser grande, enciende mi mente y hace mi corazón latir. Imagina las posibilidades cuando eres impulsado por TAMIU.
Inscríbete ahora para verano y otoño. Visita tamiu.edu y sé impulsado.
Capital Care EMS, located at 1510 Calle Norte, Suite Number 11, invites you to experience a new standard in medical transportation. Servicing Laredo and all surrounding areas, Capital Care EMS provides transports to wound care treatments, HBO treatments, dialysis treatments, doctor's appointments, radiation treatments, chemotherapy treatments, and many more. From emergency medical transports to x-rays and lab work, our state-certified EMTs and paramedics are readily available 24 hours a day when you need them most. Capital Care EMS accepts most major medical insurances, including Medicare, Medicaid, Blue Cross Blue Shield, Aetna, and many more. Capital Care EMS is locally owned and operated. Call now for your free consultation. 956-712-8911. That's 956-712-8911. Capital Care EMS.
All right, Dennis Phipps takes the first pitch. It misses for a ball. 2-0 Wichita. Tim Brown right back to work. He throws another one here that misses high. Dennis Phipps starting the day for the Laredo Lemurs, batting 321. Last year for Laredo, he hit 335. So he's a little bit off pace as far as the average goes, but he's played a few more games this year. He hits one high and deep this time to left center field. This one has a chance to get out of here, and it's gone! A home run for Dennis Phipps! Phipps's 10th home run of the season. He'll round the bases. And the Lemurs are down 2-1 in the ballgame. Well, he hit a home run similar to that on August 12th against Amarillo. Make it the 11th. It was the day before. It was actually in the first game of the series. It was pretty much right in the same spot. So Phipps gets a hold of Tim Brown here and launches one over the left center field wall, and that's going to bring up Devontre Richardson for Laredo. And the first pitch to Richardson, he ropes it down the left field line, but it's a foul ball by about a yard. So Phipps with his 10th home run of the year, RBI number 49. And he's starting to hit the long ball. No balls and a strike. So good to see Phipps get another home run. That's his second in the last four games. And the 0-1 pitch. Breaking ball swung on and missed. Richardson way out in front of that pitch. Devontre, by the way, he went 5-for-12 in the Amarillo series, so he had a nice series there. He's batting 327 on the year. The 0-2. That one dances outside for a ball. One ball and two strikes. And Tim Brown working out of the full windup. Here's the pitch. And that's called strike three on the outside corner, right at the letters to Devontre Richardson. He goes down looking, and that's the first out here in the inning. Dustin Geiger, a former member of the Wichita Wingnuts, coming up to the plate. So Geiger will have a chance to face off against his old team. When Geiger was with Wichita earlier this year, he played 33 games for him, really had a productive time. Ended up batting 351 with 9 doubles and 7 home runs. He had 28 RBIs. Also walked 16 times. So here's Tim Brown throwing home, and that one hits the outside corner for a strike. A fastball to get things started to Geiger. Geiger in the Amarillo series, he went 2-for-11. He's looking to light things up here in this series. The 0-1 pitch. That's low and outside. Lemurs with two hits. Wichita with two hits as well. But the two hits for the Wichita Wingnuts have created a 2-1 score. Here's the 1-1 delivery. A fastball in the outside corner again. One ball and two strikes to Geiger. So now Geiger's got to protect. Geiger, 6'2", 215 pounds up the plate. So a big guy down there for the Laredo Lemurs. The pitch, away, ball two. Geiger so far this year has played 8 games in a Lemurs uniform against his former team, the Wingnuts. Here's the 2-2 delivery, swung on and missed, there's strike three. So Geiger goes down swinging, back-to-back strikeouts after the Dennis Phipps home run to start off the inning. And that'll bring up the newcomer, Phil Pohl. So Geiger, by the way, batting 259 against his former team. 7 hits and 27 at-bats. He has 2 home runs against him. Both of those home runs coming back up in Wichita. So here's Phil Pohl playing in his second game for the Lemurs. He sees a pitch here. Misses outside for a ball. Nice young man, Phil Pohl. He went 2-for-2 in his first game with Laredo. He came in as a backup to Brian Peterson. He swings here and chops one foul up the third baseline. So Pohl played against Amarillo on August 12th. Today is the 14th, so that was back on Wednesday. It's Friday the 14th. Not as scary as Friday the 13th. Remember that movie, Saturday the 14th, the 1-1? A strike on the outside part of the plate, just below the belt, a fastball from Tim Brown. In there at 85 miles an hour. Tim Brown doesn't have a very hot fastball, just a very straight fastball. The 1-2. Breaking ball swung on and grounded over to the third baseman. It took a wild hop. LaRoche has it, though. He'll fire over to first base, and that'll do it for the Lemurs. So after the Dennis Phipps home run, the Lemurs go down in order. We're through two. It's a 2-1 lead in favor of Wichita. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Miller invented light beer, the original light pilsner, and that changed everything. This led to people wondering, L-I-T-E, that's how you spell light? Which led to people thumbing through their dictionaries. Which led to, there's got to be a better way to look up words. Which led to the invention of spell check. Which led to better resumes, promotions, celebrations, and happy hour. Miller Lite, we invented light beer and happy hour. You're welcome. 12 ounces contain 96 calories, 3.2 carbs, 1 protein, 0 fat. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Hey, ¿tienes algo que celebrar? ¿Que le salió el primer diente a tu hijo? ¿Que tu abuelita aprendió a tuitear? ¿Que cambiaste tu cheque? La respuesta es la misma. Pues un carnesazo. No importa lo que estés celebrando. Lo que importa es que lo celebres. Pues con un carnesazo de HEB. En HEB encuentras gran variedad de cortes a precios bajos y de buena calidad. Carnesazo. Carne asada con ganas. Solo en HEB.
South Texas families never strike out with Driscoll Health Plan. Catch the value-added services we pitch to our Medicaid members. Enjoy a free membership to specific Boys and Girls Clubs. Receive gift cards for completing Texas healthcare checkups. Restrictions and limitations may apply. Visit us at DriscollHealthPlan.com.
Before your Memorial Day party gets going, drive over to Ashley Furniture Home Store this week for our best Memorial Day sale ever. Get dramatic price reductions store-wide or no interest until January 2021. Choose from sofas and sectionals, all at unbelievably low prices. Plus, find savings on beds and amazing deals on dining rooms. It's our best Memorial Day sale ever, so don't wait. Hurry over to Ashley Furniture Home Store right now. Ashley Furniture Home Store. This is home. 4520 San Bernardo Avenue, Laredo, Texas, 956-712-2401. Subject to credit approval. Minimum monthly payments required. See store for detail.
All right, TJ Mittelstadt leads it off. He's their number three hitter for the Wichita Wingnuts. 2-1 Wichita. Two hits for each club, and Matt Lucen back up on the hill. So Matt Lucen has walked the first batter in each of the first two innings, so he's going to try to change that tone here right now. He winds and throws home to Mittelstadt. Mittelstadt shows button, takes the fastball outside. So one ball and no strikes to TJ Mittelstadt. Top of the third inning here at Uni-Trade Stadium. Moving right along. Lucen deals again. That is a strike on the inside corner, right at the belt. Another fastball from Matt. And bunt was shown again there by TJ Mittelstadt. So Mittelstadt bats from the left side, slightly open stance, and the 1-1 delivery swung on and fouled away. So make the count one ball and two strikes. TJ Mittelstadt, in the last series against Grand Prairie, he went 3-for-11, hit a couple of home runs and two RBIs, so he had a hot series with the long ball, the 1-2 pitch. That one's called strike three. He goes down looking. Home plate umpire rings him up. That's the third strikeout in the books for Matt Lucen tonight. Andy LaRoche coming up to the plate. So if you weren't with us in the first inning when Andy came up to the plate, he's the former big leaguer, Andy LaRoche. That is indeed him, his brother Adam, still in the big leagues. 2-1 Wichita. Matt Lucen winds and throws home, and that is a little bit low. And TJ Mittelstadt, by the way, is on a 7-game hitting streak, but has yet to get a hit here against the Lemurs tonight. One ball and no strikes to Andy LaRoche. He swings here and lines one down the left field line. That's going to be a base hit, and it might go for extras. LaRoche is around first. He's heading into second base. Digging it out is Ty Morrison, and that's going to be a stand-up double for LaRoche. So Matt Pageant coming up to the plate now. Matt Pageant in his last at-bat. He was one of the leadoff walks that Matt Lucen gave up. LaRoche into second base, only playing in his fifth game with Wichita. He played alongside his brother Adam back in 2008 and 2009 when he was with the Pittsburgh Pirates. That must have been pretty neat. And Andy, by the way, went 3-for-11 in the Grand Prairie series. So here's Matt Pageant with a runner at second base and one down, 2-1 Wichita. Here's the delivery, a fastball that misses low. One ball and no strikes to former Lemur, Matt Pageant. Andy LaRoche, by the way, that's his second double of the year. Here's the 1-0. A fastball inside. So two balls and no strikes to Matt Pageant. Pageant on the year. He's got himself 9 doubles in a Wichita Wingnuts uniform. So a 2-0 count. Matt Lucen will set up by the chest. He'll deliver home, and that's a fastball that's low. So now it's 3-0 to Pageant. Well, this is the same count that Pageant had earlier in the ballgame. Wind blowing out to left field right now. It's starting to pick up. I was told that it would, and it is. Here's the 3-0. Misses away. That's ball four. So that's going to put runners at first and second base. Two walks now for Matt Pageant in the ballgame, and John Nestor will make an appearance up in the batter's box, and so will Mike Meyer. Mike Meyer is going to make an appearance out on the mound, though. So he's going to bypass the batter's box and head on up to the pitcher's mound, have a conversation with Matt Lucen. So while they do that, we'll see if we can take a quick look at the scoreboard from around the American Association. Fargo and Winnipeg playing ball up in Winnipeg. Fargo's up 6-5. They're in the top of the fourth inning. Gary 1, Sioux Falls nothing. They're in the top of the fifth. St. Paul's playing Joplin. They're in Joplin. Remember, St. Paul's already clinched the North Division. So they're playing to make sure they stay healthy, and I'm sure they want to stay competitive. And they still have a record to go after. 73 wins is the record in the American Association, and I'm sure they'll make a run at that. Amarillo's up 2-1 over Grand Prairie, so they went home after they played here, and Grand Prairie went from Wichita down to Amarillo. Rockland 3, Lincoln 1, that game in the bottom of the fifth. The Rockland Boulders won yesterday. They've won 11 games in a row. Runners at first and second base for the Wichita Wingnuts. There's one out, and John Nestor at the plate. The Lemurs looking for a double play ball. Here's the pitch, a fastball away. Kansas City's up 2-1 over Sioux City. They're in the bottom of the fifth inning. So there's your AA scoreboard, the American Association of Professional Baseball. One ball and no strikes. Loosen kicks and deals, and that one swung on, and a slow roller up to tie Forney at short. Forney looks back to second, throws it there. The flip back to first base is not going to be in time. But the Lemurs do get one out. LaRoche moves up to third base on the play. Paginet is out on the nice play by Ty Forney, a 6-4 put out. And John Nestor reaches on the fielder's choice, and that'll bring up Harrison Kane again. Well, Harrison Kane hit that 2-run home run in the last inning. And right now it's 2-1 in favor of Wichita, so his home run is the difference in the game right now. It's the first game of a 3-game series between these two clubs, a big series for the Laredo Lemurs as they sit 5 games back behind Wichita. Lemurs would love to get a sweep and get themselves a whole lot closer, but not an easy task. This team is good. Here's the pitch, a curveball to Kane. He takes it for a strike as it nibbles on the outside part of the plate. No balls and a strike. So LaRoche over at third base. Over at first is Nestor. And the 0-1 pitch. Kane shows bunt, pulls back, and watches it glide by. So that misses outside. One ball and one strike to Harrison Kane. So Lucen puts his foot in the rubber. Holds the baseball behind his back. Now he'll bring his hands together. Here's the 1-1 pitch to Kane. A curveball swung on. Hit in the air into right field. Dennis Phipps has a beat on this one. He's calling everybody off. He says, I got it. And he does. So that'll be the third out. In the inning, no runs on a hit, no errors, and two left. We're going to go to the bottom of the third inning. Lemurs coming up to the plate. They're down 2-1. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
3-2-1, number one. That's Laredo's number one Chevy dealer. Family Chevrolet turns the best day ever into the best month ever. 15% off, not good enough, but 25% off, now that makes it the best month ever. With over 600 vehicles available, makes it the best pricing ever. 2015 Equinox, 2015 Traverse, not 15, but 25% off. And the best financing rates for the best month ever, 1.9 interest. Family Chevrolet of Laredo.com. Come see why the deals are always better at Family Chevrolet. Family Chevrolet is the number one volume Chevy dealer for a reason. Every customer rides during our spring cleaning closeout sale with massive price cuts on 600 Chevys. New 2015 Chevy Cruze. How about 25% off MSRP? Wow, that's huge. Or only $199 a month. New 2015 Malibu for only $269 a month. Or 25% off MSRP. Plus 2 years free maintenance and a 100,000-mile warranty. It's a spring cleaning closeout sale happening now at the number one volume Chevy dealer. Come see why the deals are always better at Family Chevrolet.
Sweating through another barn burner at your team's bar?
Sure am.
Wish you had some ice-cold refreshment?
You bet.
Then Coors Light may be right for you. Could result in meeting new people, epic fist bumps, epic forearm bumps, epicer chest bumps, touchdown dancing, breakdancing, line dancing, dancing like nobody's watching, awesome refreshment, refreshment for the win, and one-of-a-kind Rocky Mountain cold refreshment. Ask your bartender for Coors Light today.
Definitely.
When cold refreshment calls, Coors Light answers. Frost-brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
All right, Juan Silverio going to start it off for the Laredo Lemurs as we go to the bottom of the third. It's Silverio, Forney, and then we'll go up to the top of the order for Ty Morrison. 2-1 Wichita. Tim Brown rocks and fires, and the pitch is low and outside. So the Lemurs down by a run. A solo home run by Dennis Phipps in the second inning as the Lemurs on the board. The pitch swung and a liner into left field, a base hit. So Silverio picks up a single. That one was lined onto the infield. Dirt took one hop and went into the outfield. That'll bring up Ty Forney. Well, it'll be interesting to see what manager Pete Incaviglia does here with Ty Forney. Not a bad situation for a bunt, but I'm not sure the Lemurs want to play small ball right now. Might not be a good idea to start playing small ball this early in the ball game. Lemurs are down a run. So we'll see what Forney does. He does show bunt. He pulls back, and Nestor acts as if he's going to throw over to first base, but Matt Pageant is off the bag, and the second baseman Vargas is far away from the bag as he started running over there due to the bunt shown there by Ty Forney. Ty Forney on the year, batting 149 for Laredo. So Vario with his lead, bunt shown again, and he'll pull back and watch it miss outside. So two balls and no strikes to Forney. So a 2-0 count. We'll probably see Forney square again, I would guess, until Tim Brown throws a strike. And that's bunted at. Bunted right back up to Tim Brown. Brown will just go ahead and double pump and throw over to first base. They get the out there, and Silverio does move up to second. So on the play, it goes 1-4 on the putout. Silverio up to second base, and one down. Ty Morrison, the top of the order, coming up now for Laredo. Ty Morrison in the Amarillo series ended up going 3-for-13. He scored 5 runs for the Lemurs. And he starts the day batting 364 for Laredo. Here's the pitch. A fastball outside. So a little bit about Tim Brown for you, starting pitcher today for Wichita. He has pitched twice against the Lemurs so far this year. And he has a 1.88 ERA. He throws home, and that one swung on and lifted in the air down the left field line. So let's start that over with the Tim Brown stats for you. On the season, he's 8-2 with a 3.64 ERA through 15 games. He's thrown in 96 innings, so he's only almost up to 100 innings. Well, he will be up to 100 tonight as long as he goes 4 innings. And it looks like he'll do that. Here's the pitch. Swung and a liner in the left field for a base hit. Just past the diving shortstop, Taylor Smart. The Lemurs have runners at the corner. Silverio is at third base. The Lemurs are down a run. And they have runners at the corners. So Silverio moves up to third. Ty Morrison in with the single. That's his second hit of the game. So the Lemurs threatening now with one out. And coming up to the plate is Jeudy Valdez. Yeah, so Tim Brown, 8-2 on the year with a 3.64 ERA. In 2014 against Laredo, Tim Brown went 3-1 through 5 games. He made 4 starts against him and put up that 1.88 ERA. This year, through 2 games, he's 2-0 against Laredo with a 3.0 ERA. Here's the pitch. Jeudy shows bunt. He'll bunt it foul, and the Lemurs could have had a nice play there with Juan Silverio coming down the third baseline. No balls and a strike to Valdez. So overall, through the 2 years that Tim Brown's been in the American Association, he's 5-1 against Laredo through 7 games and 6 starts. And he's got a 2.24 ERA through that time. He has struck out 22 Lemurs coming into tonight. And he has 2 strikeouts tonight against Laredo. No balls and a strike. 2-1 Wichita. Runners at the corners for the Laredo Lemurs. And Jeudy Valdez back into the batter's box. Tim Brown sets low, and he throws home. Bunt shown again. It's chopped at. Coming home is Silverio. The throw to the plate, the tag, and it's in time to get Silverio out. So the Lemurs try to squeeze home Silverio, but they can't get it done. The ball ended up popping off of the plate, which went high into the air, and then it just rolled right out to Tim Brown. And the play goes 1-2 on the putout. So that'll be the second out in the inning. Moving up to second base is Morrison. And Jeudy Valdez will be safe on the fielder's choice. That'll bring up Kevin Taylor. So the hot-hitting Kevin Taylor will get a chance. Taylor in his first at-bat, he grounded out to the second baseman. So runners at first and second base. And here's the pitch to Taylor. He watches it miss outside. Taylor batting 333 to start the night. He went 3-for-5 in yesterday's ball game. Taylor, one of his hits was a 2-run home run. He also had a couple of singles, ended the day with 3 RBIs, the 1-0. A changeup low and inside. Taylor also looking to keep that hitting streak alive. Taylor currently 7th in the league with a batting average of .333. So he's popped back up into the top 10 in hitting in the American Association as of late with his hitting streak. Here comes the 2-0. A fastball. That one pegs the outside corner. Just below the belt. 2-1 now to Kevin Taylor. Taylor, a former member of the Dodgers organization, and went to college at Western Nevada College in Carson City, Nevada. Here's the 2-1 pitch. It misses low. So a 3-1 count now, and the Lemurs are a ball away from loading the bases for Dennis Phipps. Well, that wouldn't be a bad idea, right? Dennis Phipps just coming off that home run ball. So we obviously saw Tim Brown well in his first at-bat. And, of course, Kevin Taylor with a good eye. Taylor on the year with 52 walks. He's currently third in the league. Here's the 3-1. It's high for a ball. That will be ball four. That will load the bases for the Lemurs. And Dennis Phipps coming up to the plate. So Phipps walking up to the plate. He'll go around the backside of the home plate umpire and the catcher. Phipps on the year with 14 hits so far this season against Wichita. He started the day batting 310 against him, and that goes up with that base hit. So the bases are loaded for Phipps. You'll see a breaking ball in the dirt. And one was smothered by the catcher, John Nestor. One ball and no strikes. Lemurs down by a run. Bases loaded in the bottom of the third inning. A big situation here for Laredo. They can do some big damage. Try to jump ahead here against Tim Brown. Not an easy task. The 1-0. Swung on. Hit well. On a line into center field. Here comes Ray. Ray will reach down and make the catch at his knees. Taking away a base hit from Dennis Phipps. Phipps hit it just a little bit too hard. And that ends the inning. The Lemurs get no runs on two hits. They have no errors, and there are three left. We're going to the top of the fourth. Wichita up 2-1.
Right now, you could be working towards an exciting new career in business administration. At Catholic College Laredo, you'll have the chance to gain professional skills and hands-on training. Earning a business degree could open the door to new career opportunities in fields such as accounting, human resources, banking, and marketing. Start on the path to your new career at Kaplan College. Call 800-617-0800. Right now, you could be working towards an exciting new career in business administration. At Kaplan College Laredo, you'll have the chance to gain professional skills and hands-on training. Earning a business degree could open the door to new career opportunities in fields such as accounting, human resources, banking, and marketing. Start on the path to your new career at Kaplan College. Call 800-617-0800.
Kaplan College does not guarantee employment or career advancement. Information about programs at www.kaplancollege.com/consumer-info.
Today at Whataburger, we're cooking the Honey Mustard Water Chicken Club. The chicken is hot and fresh. It's got melted Monterey Jack cheese topped with lettuce, tomato, bacon, and then the honey mustard adds a nice sweet flavor to it.
All the flavors come together just perfect. I mean, not only do I want to eat it, but I keep wanting to look at it.
The crunchiness of the bacon adds a really nice texture.
Honey mustard and chicken just go together. You know, sweet and savory, it's a perfect mix.
Try the new Honey Mustard Water Chicken Club. Only at Whataburger for a limited time.
Looking to travel this summer? If the year-round flights to Las Vegas aren't fit for you, take advantage of Allegiant's direct flights from Laredo International Airport to Orlando. For as low as $119 round trip, you and your family can be in Orlando in 2.5 hours. Fly in comfort from your Laredo International Airport. Visit Allegiant.com for details and specials. Taylor Smart to lead things off for the Wichita Wingnuts. Wingnuts up by a run. Unfortunately, the Lemurs leave the bases loaded in the bottom of the third inning. Here's the first pitch to Smart. Smart will bunt it foul right behind the catcher. So no balls and a strike. Taylor Smart, since joining the Wichita Wingnuts, batting 111. Earlier this year, he played 50 games with the Amarillo Thunderheads, ended up hitting 206 for Amarillo. So he had 33 hits and 183 plate appearances, over 160 total at-bats. No balls and a strike. Loosen kicks high and throws home, and that is a strike on the outside corner. 0-2 now to Taylor Smart. Taylor Smart was a draft pick by the Seattle Mariners back in the 26th round of the 2014 draft out of the University of Tennessee. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Curveball in the dirt, blocked by Phil Pohl. Yeah, so Taylor Smart spent a short time in affiliated ball, played 44 games with the Everett Aqua Sox of the Northwest League, and after that started playing independent ball in 2015. He's got a nice glove on him, though. Always fun to watch him play shortstop or third. Here's the pitch. That's a breaking ball called strike three. So he takes a look at that one, goes down looking. That's going to be the fourth strikeout on the night for Matt Lucen. So one down in the top of the fourth inning. Leo Vargas coming up to the plate for the Wichita Wingnuts. So Matt Lucen into the full windup. Here's the pitch. Fastball swung on, lifted softly into right field. Coming on, Dennis Phipps. Phipps will get underneath it and make the catch. And quickly two down. And the Lemurs could use a nice quick inning here. Every inning so far, there have been base runners on. And the Wichita Wingnuts in the first and the third left a runner at third base. They scored their two runs off the Harrison Kane home run back in the second inning. Here's Jace Ray into the batter's box. So Jace Ray, the leadoff man, going to bat from the left side. Lucen, the righty, throws home, and it's a fastball that misses low. Ray on the day, he walked and stole second base in the first, and he ended up picking up a single in the second. 1-0, Lucen peers over the mitt. Into the windup he goes. Here's the pitch, swung in a ground ball over to the right side. In front of it, Kevin Taylor. He'll double pump and throw over to first base, and that's the first 1-2-3 inning turned in by Matt Lucen. So a nice job there by Lucen. And we're through 3.5. 2-1 Wichita.
Miller invented light beer, the original light pilsner, and that changed everything. This led to fewer guys with beer bellies, which led to more women attracted to those guys, which led to dates, second dates, wedding bells, and honeymoons, which led to hubbada hubbada, boom, which led to you. Miller Lights, we invented light beer, and you, you're welcome. 12 ounces contain 96 calories, 3.2 carbs, 1 protein, 0 fat. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Texas Inflatable Rentals has Laredo's largest water slides. Real proud to say that we serve the greater Laredo area and supply slip sliding fun for kids of all ages. Texas Inflatable Rentals has a huge selection of inflatables for every budget. And to add to the party, we rent tables, chairs, snow cone machines, popcorn machines, and cotton candy machines that will help take your party to the next level. We also have moonwalks and bounce houses. Contact Texas Inflatable Rentals at 956-436-3909 or at texasinflatablerentals.com. And book with the coupon code LEMURS for a 10% discount. That's Texas Inflatable Rentals, Laredo's largest water slide.
All right, Lemurs coming up to the plate in the bottom of the fourth. And the Lemurs trail 2-1 here at Uni-Trade Stadium. So it's going to be Richardson, Geiger, and Phil Pohl coming up to the plate for the Laredo Lemurs against Tim Brown. Tell you a little bit more about Tim Brown and where he's been throughout his career in minor league baseball. He throws a pitch here, and it hits the outside corner for a strike. Brown was born in St. Louis, Missouri. He's currently 28 years old. He went to Pittsburgh State University in Pittsburgh, Kansas. Here's the 0-1 pitch. Swung in a one-hop liner into the glove of the second baseman, diving for it. Vargas. Vargas gets up quickly, throws over to first base, and Devontre Richardson's retired. A nice play there by Leo Vargas. Vargas going to his right, diving for the ball after it took one hop and went into his glove. So Dustin Geiger will be able to come up to the plate now for the Laredo Lemurs. Yeah, Tim Brown, throughout his professional career, started off back in 2009 at the age of 22, the tender age of 22 years old. He played in the American Association that year for the Lincoln Salt Dogs. Here's the first pitch to Geiger. That's taken for a ball. Fastball away. And went 5-1 that season with a 2.59 ERA over 17 ball games. Then he got picked up by the Philadelphia Phillies the next season as Geiger takes a strike on the outside corner. One ball, one strike. Lemurs down by a run. Bottom of four. Next pitch, a liner into right field, and coming on quickly, going into a slide is Mittelstadt. Mittelstadt will make the catch on the nice slide. So, man, the defense on the side of the Wichita Wingnuts here right now, very impressive. Phil Pohl, the batter. So after that short time for Tim Brown with the Philadelphia Phillies, he only played with their Gulf Coast team. And he only played in seven games, and then ended up back in independent baseball again with the Lincoln Salt Dogs in 2010. So here's Pohl. Pohl takes a pitch. It misses outside. Lemurs down by a run. Bottom of four. Yeah, so he played with Lincoln for a couple of more seasons. Also spent some time in Grand Prairie. And the fastball swung on and fouled away. Then he found himself in the Frontier League back in 2012 and 2013. Frontier League, he played for the Gateway Grizzlies. Had some good seasons as Phil Pohl swings and misses. In 2012, Tim Brown put up a record of 12 wins and 2 losses and a 2.28 ERA. In 2013, he sported a 13-3 win-loss record. The 1-2 swung on in a liner into right field. On the run, Mittelstadt again, and that one's going to fall in front of Mittelstadt. So a nice little hit there on a line by Phil Pohl, his third hit in a Lemurs uniform. And Juan Silverio will be the next batter for Laredo. Yeah, so a couple of good seasons there for Tim Brown with the Gateway Grizzlies. And then the Wichita Wingnuts picked him up for the 2014 campaign. He went 10-4 last year, and so far this season, he's 8-2. Look at his overall record throughout his professional career. He's been a winner. He's 65-30 as a pro. 3.34 ERA all-time. The pitch to Silverio. A fastball high. Might have been a little bit outside as well. One run on 5 hits for Laredo. 2 runs on 3 hits for the Wichita Wingnuts. Silverio all the way in the very back of the batter's box. Here's the delivery home, and a changeup hits the outside corner for a strike. So that one's slightly above the belt to Silverio. Silverio has a base hit already today. He actually led off the third inning for the Lemurs with that base hit, but he got thrown out trying to come home on the... Well, there's a 1-1 pitch lofted into left field. Charging in is Harrison Kane. He'll get there and make the catch. That's the third out. But as I was saying, Silverio was trying to come home on the bunt attempt by Jeudy Valdez earlier in the ballgame. It was a kind of like a suicide squeeze. It wasn't all that exciting, though, as the Lemurs saw Jeudy Valdez bunt right back to Tim Brown. Brown threw home. Silverio slid into the glove, and he was out at the plate. What do you do, right? Well, we're through 4 innings here. It's still a 2-1 ball game in favor of Wichita. We're going to head to that inning. The top of the 5th is coming up. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Falcon Bank and the Laredo Lemurs are a winning combination. At Falcon, they know what counts. Personalized service, attention to detail, and genuine commitment to helping customers achieve their dreams. Falcon Bank, guided by faith, grounded by family, and committed to you.
Need a little spark in your life? Then come on out to Uni-Trade Stadium for Friday Night Fireworks. Tickets start as low as $5, and you'll get to see great baseball and great fireworks all in one night. To get tickets, call 956-7-LEMURS or go online at LaredoLemurs.com. I'll see you at the ballpark. Hey, Lemurs fans, every Thursday night at Uni-Trade Stadium is a Thirsty Thursday. Come on out and enjoy cold Miller Lite draft beers for only $1. That's right, beer for a buck. You can get tickets online at LaredoLemurs.com or by phone at 956-7-LEMURS. I'll see you at the ballpark.
Unitrade continues to provide solutions in foreign trade through a highly satisfactory customs brokerage service. Unitrade has quality trained personnel devoted to the highest level of customer service. For all your transportation, distribution, and consolidation needs, it's Unitrade. Chavarrias Plumbing's the number one choice for any plumbing problem. Chavarrias is a full-service company with up-to-date technology trained professionals. With over 30 years of service to the community, Chavarrias is still growing strong. Visit ChavarriasPlumbing.com. And go Lemurs!
Core Business Solutions is a proud sponsor of Lemurs Baseball. Core Business Solutions services the 17 southernmost counties of Texas as well as areas of northern Mexico. They offer a wide range of high-tech solutions for businesses and organizations. Make Core Business Solutions your solution today.
David Espinoza to lead it off for Wichita. He'll be followed up by TJ Mittelstadt, and then Andy LaRoche will be coming up to the plate. Between those three guys, they're 1-for-6. Andy LaRoche has the lone base hit. He has a double. So Matt Lucen back up there on the hill for the Laredo Lemurs. Here's David Espinoza. Espinoza out of Venezuela. He's 33 years old. He was a first-round draft pick by the Reds. Here's the pitch. Swung on and popped up over our heads, and that'll get out of play. He was actually drafted out of Coral Gables, Florida high school. It was actually Gulliver Prep High School in Coral Gables, Florida. Let's get that correct. No balls and a strike to David Espinoza. He's batting 291 on the year. Here's the pitch. A fastball that misses low. So yeah, Espinoza, 33 years old. Yeah, drafted in the first round by the Reds back in 2000. A 1-1 pitch. That's a strike. Glides across the plate on the inside corner. One ball and two strikes. He played in the Tigers organization as well. Only spent a short time with the Reds. Played 2 seasons in the Reds system. and got traded over to the Tigers. He actually ended up playing with their manager, Kevin Hooper, in the Tiger system. 1-2 pitch, a curveball low. So that's how David Espinosa and Kevin Hooper know each other. They ran across each other's paths playing for the Detroit Tigers organization. And Espinosa started off playing in Dayton for the Dragons back in the Midwest League back in 2001. Played 122 games in his first year as a pro. The 2-2 pitch, another curveball swung on and missed. Espinosa goes down swinging. And Matt Lucen has that curveball working right now. Lucen in the fourth inning set the side down in order. So he did a nice job. That's the fifth strikeout for Lucen up on the board. So here's TJ Mittelstadt. Mittelstadt has already struck out twice, so let's see if Lucen can make it three times in the early going of this ballgame. Lemurs down by a run. It's a 2-1 lead for Wichita. And Lucen delivers again. That one is low and inside. So here's some of the numbers for Lucen on the season. A 3-5 record, a 4.12 ERA through 15 starts. Now they're going to ask for some more baseballs from the ball boy. Lucen's last start came against Sioux Falls. He pitched six innings. He gave up three runs, but only one was earned. He gave up 10 hits, walked a batter, and struck out four. Lemurs ended up winning that game 6-3. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Swung in a liner down the left field line. It's going to be a foul ball. And Lucen's best start of the season came in a losing effort for the Laredo Lemurs. He actually pitched very well against this Wichita club. On July 8th, he pitched in seven innings and did not allow a run. Unfortunately, the Lemurs could not muster a run on the other side, and they went on to lose 1-0. So a pretty devastating blow there. Not fun. Here's the 1-1 pitch. A swing and a liner into center field. Devontre Richardson on the move. He'll get there easily as he sidesteps over to his left. Boy, that ball was smoked by TJ Mittelstadt, but Devontre Richardson able to get there pretty smoothly. Here's Andy LaRoche. Keep on to say Adam LaRoche, his brother, but it's Andy coming up to the plate. Yeah, Matt Lucen altogether has pitched in two games against Wichita this year. Here's the first pitch to LaRoche. It misses low. So Lucen's record against Wichita is 0-1 with a .69 ERA. The 1-0 pitch, fastball swung on, popped up shallow left center, charging in Ty Morrison. Calling him off is Ty Forney. Forney will make the catch, and that's another 1-2-3 inning turned in by Matt Lucen. So he's retired seven in a row now for his club, and he'll head back into the dugout, get some rest, and the Lemurs need to get their hitting shoes on here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Lemurs are down 2-1. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
For all of your vehicle collision repair and paint needs, there's only one place to turn, Mike's Paint Place. Mike's Paint Place has computerized color matching and digital imaging. They also do full frame and suspension repairs. Stop by and see Mike's Paint Place today at 6410 Polaris Drive in Laredo.
Tokyo Garden of Laredo is located at 2515 East Del Mar Boulevard, and they serve the best sushi in town. Stop by Tokyo Garden for a quick lunch or a fancy dinner. Either way, you're going to enjoy our fine cuisine. Did you just get off work? Then come on by and check out our happy hour specials. Tokyo Garden, where you'll find the best sushi in Laredo.
Right now, when you sign up for a Gold's Gym membership, you'll get tons of extras completely free. Confidence, free. Compliments from your coworkers, free. And the desire to wear tiny bathing suits, you guessed it, free. You'll be stronger with extras, and you'll be stronger with Gold's Gym. Know your own strength. Tiny bathing suit not included.
Pro Mega Signs of Laredo is there for all of your printing and signage needs. We can be found at 1615 Jackman Road in Laredo, or you can reach us by phone at 956-723-2110. Again, that's 956-723-2110. If you need a sign, big or small, come to Pro Mega Signs of Laredo, where your print job is just around the corner.
All right, they're playing the frisbee toss in between innings here at Unitrade Stadium. You get a couple of contestants. They try to throw some frisbees into a fishing net. It's a whole lot of fun. That's all I have to say. It's a good time here at the ballpark. Come on out. If you're in Laredo, make sure you join us. Tonight is fireworks night. You still have some time to get on out here to watch the fireworks. Here's Ty Forney stepping into the box. He hits a ground ball over to the third baseman, LaRoche. Before LaRoche hits the clip of the grass, he'll go and throw over to first base, and that's going to be a putout. So 5-3 goes the putout. And we go up to the top of the order for Ty Morrison. Morrison with a couple of base hits already in the ballgame. Lemurs down by a run. It's 2-1 Wichita. Home runs are the difference here in the ballgame. A two-run home run by Harrison Kane, a former Lemur, and a solo home run by Dennis Phipps for the Lemurs in the bottom of the second inning. So all the runs coming in the second inning for both clubs. So here's Morrison. He'll take a fastball on the outside corner just above the knee for a strike. No balls and a strike. Five hits for Laredo, three hits for the Wichita Wingnuts. Brown winds and throws. That's a changeup. It's low for a ball. A 1-1 count now to Morrison. Yeah, so Morrison with a single in the first and a single in the third inning. He's seen Tim Brown well. And the kick and the throw home, and that one swung on. Hit in the air out to center field. Jace Ray will move around. He'll dance around, actually, and make the catch. And two up and two down here for the Lemurs in the fifth. And that'll bring up Jeudy Valdez. J.D. Valdez reached on a fielder's choice in his last at bat. He tried to lay down that bunt, but the Wichita Wingnuts were able to get an out at the plate with Juan Silverio trying to come in to score. It was a squeeze play. It wasn't all that exciting, though, because we saw it happen before. Actually, Valdez had fouled a bunt attempt off earlier in the at bat. The first pitch to Valdez this time misses high, so the Lemurs were trying to do the squeeze play, but usually it's supposed to be exciting, and you're supposed to get it down the first time, and you're like, oh, here comes the squeeze play, and it comes out of nowhere, and you're like, yes. The 1-0 pitch swung on in a ground ball, one hopped over to LaRoche at third. He's on the grass. He'll do a soft toss over to first base. It's in time to get the out, and the Lemurs go down in order. We're going to head to the sixth inning. It's 2-1 Wichita. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
We all know we can accomplish more when we're ready. That's why I've chosen Texas A&M International University. I want a four-year degree and the opportunities that it brings. TAMU has welcomed me and more than 7,000 students from around the world. TAMU powers me to greatness, ignites my mind, and propels me to my future and my impact. Imagine the possibilities when you're powered by TAMU.
Register now for summer and fall. Visit TAMU.edu and get powered.
Since Ascending Technologies opened for business in 1998, they have worked to establish solid relationships with their clients. They are set to maintain the highest standards of service and integrity and to perform work of only the highest quality, achieving client satisfaction on every project. They have attained these goals through a tradition of care and professional pride. They serve a wide range of corporations and small business franchises. Ascending Technologies has the tools and expertise for any technical need that your business may have. Call us here in Laredo at 725-2654. That's 725-2654 for Ascending Technologies.
Todos sabemos que podemos lograr más cuando estamos listos. Por eso, decidí matricularme en Texas A&M International University. Quiero un título universitario y las oportunidades que me brindará. TAMU me ha recibido a mí y a 7,000 estudiantes de todo el mundo. TAMU me impulsa a ser grande, enciende mi mente y hace mi corazón latir. Imagina las posibilidades cuando eres impulsado por TAMU.
Inscríbete ahora para verano y otoño. Visita tamu.edu y sé impulsado.
All right, Matt Pageant's going to lead it off for the Wichita Wingnuts as we go to the sixth inning. Moving right along here in this one. Fun evening here at Uni-Trade Stadium. A lot of fans having a good old time. Remember, the Lemurs are running out of home games, so if you haven't been out to the ballpark yet, I highly suggest you get your tickets and come on out to the yard. Lemurs have a three-game series here this weekend. Well, this one's almost done, so two more games, one on Saturday and one on Sunday. Don't forget, the Sunday game is a 6 o'clock start here from Unitrade Stadium. Here's Pageant, here's Lucen. They go at it, and the fastball is inside. 2-1 Wichita. Got their two runs back in the second inning. A two-run home run by Harrison Kane. And the 1-0 pitch. That one is very high. And the Lemurs are going to head on the road after they played the three here against Wichita. And they're going to head on up to Sioux Falls. They're going all the way up to South Dakota. So it's going to be a long ride in the bus for the Lemurs. Here's the 2-0 pitch. Swung on and missed. Matt Pageant going for it there. just a little bit behind the 87-mile-an-hour fastball. So, yeah, they have three up in Sioux Falls, and then they go and play this team once again, the Wichita Wingnuts. The 2-1 pitch. A strike on the outside corner. Pageant doesn't like the call too much. He thought that one was away. Yeah, so the Lemurs play that Sioux Falls series, and then on the way home, they'll stop in Wichita. So that way they can break up the trip home a little bit. And then they only come back for three games against Grand Prairie. Two balls and two strikes. The kick and the throw home, and that is called strike three. Pageant goes down looking. Eight in a row retired by Matt Lucen. He's got another strikeout in the books. That's number six on the night. John Nestor coming up to the plate. So the Lemurs really with a tough road to hoe over the next couple of games, especially with two rough road trips coming up. The first one up to Sioux Falls and Wichita is a six-game roadie. Here's the pitch to Nestor, a fastball at the knees. And then they come home, like I said, they play three against Grand Prairie. Then they go out for eight games. Amarillo for four, Kansas City for four. And then they come home to end the season for three games. The 0-1 pitch. Called a strike on the outside part of the plate, a fastball there, right across the chest where it says nuts on the chest of John Nestor. Nuts. Their slogan up in Wichita is go nuts. No balls and two strikes. 2-1 Wichita. Harrison Kane on deck. Lucen shakes his head yes. He kicks high. He throws home and the pitch misses high. So that's how the season's going to end up here for the Laredo Lemurs. The question is, are they going to make the playoffs? Well, if the season ended today, the answer would be no to that question. But still some time to make up some ground, and they do have a lot of games against this club. The 1-2 pitch. Curveball swung on. Hit in the air. Shallow center field. Coming in, Devontre Richardson. He'll get there, camp, and make the easy catch. So another one in the books for Matt Lucen. Nine in a row retired here for Lucen. Looking to make it number 10 as Harrison Kane comes up to the plate. Kane in his last at bat, he flew out to right field. We're in the top of the sixth inning, 2-1 Wichita. And Kane throws, or excuse me, Lucen throws. It's a strike on the outside part of the plate, placed finally at the belt of Harrison Kane. Kane wearing his black belt tonight, along with the rest of his teammates. No balls and a strike. Lucen peers over the mitt. Into the windup he goes. The pitch is swung on, popped up right side. Going into foul territory is Geiger, the first baseman, and it's just out of his reach. That one actually might have landed out of play, but I can't tell. I know it hit on a hard surface and bounced up into the stands. The only question was, did it actually bounce in play or did it bounce out of play? It was so close to the fence over there, it's hard to tell. From the distance that we're at right now, anyway. No balls and two strikes to Kane. So Matt Lucen way ahead in this count. And let's see how he dances around Harrison Kane here on the next pitch. Definitely don't want to give him anything good to hit here on the 0-2. Here's the pitch. It swung on and fouled off. So that one was hittable. It looked like it was on the inside corner of the plate before Kane swung the bat. So it keeps the count at no balls and two strikes. The art of pitching. It's always fun to watch these guys deal home. Here's the 0-2 again. Curveball in the dirt. That one will go all the way back to the backstop. One of the ball boys will grab that one. It's funny, during the defensive side, the ball boy is a ball boy for the Lemurs, and then when he's on the offensive side, he's the bat boy all of a sudden. He has two jobs. Here's the 1-2 kick and throw. Curveball swung on and hit down the left field line, but that one's going to get out of play here at the ballpark. So the count will stay one ball and two strikes. So a new baseball for Matt Lucen. Harrison Kane taking a look at his bat, making sure it's okay before he tries to swing again. He swings a beautiful ash-colored bat. Looks like it's brand new right out of the box. The 1-2, curveball, called strike three. That'll do it for Harrison Kane. That does it for the Wingnuts. Matt Lucen has set down 10 in a row. We're going to head to the bottom of the sixth inning. The Lemurs are down 2-1. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
Capital Care EMS, located at 1510 Calle Norte, Suite Number 11, invites you to experience a new standard in medical transportation. Servicing Laredo and all surrounding areas, Capital Care EMS provides transports to wound care treatments, HBO treatments, dialysis treatments, doctor's appointments, radiation treatments, chemotherapy treatments, and many more. From emergency medical transports to x-rays and lab work, our state-certified EMTs and paramedics are readily available 24 hours a day when you need them most. Capital Care EMS accepts most major medical insurances, including Medicare, Medicaid, Blue Cross Blue Shield, Aetna, and many more. Capital Care EMS is locally owned and operated. Call now for your free consultation. 956-712-8911. That's 956-712-8911. Capital Care EMS, creating a new standard in medical transportation. Capital Care EMS, the official ambulance of your Laredo Lemurs.
Miller invented light beer, the original light pilsner, and that changed everything. This led to people wondering, L-I-T-E, that's how you spell light? Which led to people thumbing through their dictionaries. Which led to, there's gotta be a better way to look up words. Which led to the invention of spell check. Which led to better resumes, promotions, celebrations, and happy hour. Miller Lite, we invented light beer and happy hour. You're welcome. 12 ounces contain 96 calories, 3.2 carbs, 1 protein, 0 fat. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
And away we go as the first pitch to the new batter. Misses inside and low. Kevin Taylor up at the plate now for the Laredo Lemurs. And here's the pitch. Swung and a liner into center field. On the run, Jace Ray. He'll get there and make the catch. Well, Taylor gave it a good ride. Jace Ray was able to get there and make a nice catch and get in front of the ball in left center field. One down, Dennis Phipps the batter now for the Laredo Lemurs. So Phipps with the lone run up on the board for the Laredo Lemurs tonight. He hit his 10th home run back in the second inning. Here's the pitch. He swings and fouls that one off, so it's a 2-1 game with Wichita in the lead. In case you're just joining us, thanks for being here. Phipps with his black socks all the way up to his kneecaps, wearing number 55 on his back. He's got a little sway in the box, and he looks at a breaking ball that misses low. After this is going to be Devontre Richardson for the Laredo Lemurs. Lemurs' last base runner came in the fourth inning, a single by Phil Pohl. Here's the 1-1 pitch. That one is swung on and softly lined over by the Lemurs' dugout. That one had a lot of spin to it. So that's a foul ball. One ball and two strikes to Phipps. And Tim Brown gets the sign. He'll kick and deal. That one is swung on and missed. Phipps goes down swinging. Two down. And Devontre Richardson will be the batter for the Laredo Lemurs. Well, it looks like both pitchers are getting comfortable out there on the hill right now. Matt Lusing doing well. Tim Brown doing well. Tim Brown has retired the side in order twice over the fourth and the fifth inning, and he's threatening to do it here again. And that pitch misses outside to Devontre Richardson. Lemurs down by a run. 2-1 Wichita. The pitch. Changeup swung on. Hit well into left field, but it's going to go foul. So one ball and one strike to Devontre. So tomorrow night, a 7:30 start here at Uni-Trade Stadium, and Sunday is a 6 o'clock tilt between the two clubs. The 1-1 pitch. Swung and a ground ball right back to Tim Brown. He'll run over to first base. Underhand toss over to Matt Padgett. And the Lemurs go down in order, and now Tim Brown has sat down 10 straight. So it's a battle of pitchers right now, but the Wichita Wingnuts have the lead up on the scoreboard. It's 2-1 Wichita.
South Texas families never strike out with Driscoll Health Plan. Catch the value-added services we pitch to our Medicaid members. Enjoy a free membership to specific Boys and Girls Clubs. Receive gift cards for completing Texas healthcare checkups. Restrictions and limitations may apply. Visit us at DriscollHealthPlan.com.
Before your Memorial Day party gets going, drive over to Ashley Furniture Home Store this week for our best Memorial Day sale ever. Get dramatic price reductions store-wide or no interest until January 2021. Choose from sofas and sectionals, all at unbelievably low prices. Plus, find savings on beds and amazing deals on dining rooms. It's our best Memorial Day sale ever, so don't wait. Hurry over to Ashley Furniture Home Store right now. Ashley Furniture Home Store. This is home. 4520 San Bernardo Avenue, Laredo, Texas, 956-712-2401. Subject to credit approval. Minimum monthly payments required. See store for details.
3, 2, 1, number one. That's Laredo's number one Chevy dealer. Family Chevrolet turns the best day ever into the best month ever. 15% off, not good enough, but 25% off, now that makes it the best month ever. With over 600 vehicles available, makes it the best pricing ever. 2015 Equinox, 2015 Traverse, not 15, but 25% off. And the best financing rates for the best month ever, 1.9 interest. Family Chevrolet of Laredo.com. Come see why the deals are always better at Family Chevrolet. Family Chevrolet is the number one volume Chevy dealer for a reason. Every customer rides during our spring cleaning closeout sale with massive price gifts on 600 Chevys. New 2015 Chevy Cruze. How about 25% off MSRP? Wow, that's huge. Or only $199 a month. New 2015 Malibu for only $269 a month. Or 25% off MSRP. Plus 2 years free maintenance and a 100,000-mile warranty. It's a spring cleaning closeout sale happening now at the number one volume Chevy dealer. Come see why the deals are always better at Family Chevrolet.
All right, Taylor Smart to lead it off for Wichita. And Matt Lewson going back to work after retiring 10 straight batters. You can make it 11 if you go back to when he allowed John Nestor to reach on a fielder's choice and the runner going to second base got out. Here's a ground ball out the middle. That's going to end it anyway. So a base hit for Taylor Smart, a C&I single for him. So 10 straight in a row retired by Matt Lewson, goes by the wayside. And like I was saying, you can make it 11 straight if you go back to the runner getting out at second base. Matt Pageant and John Nestor taking over at first base. I guess it's just the way you see it. So Leo Vargas is going to get a chance to hit with Taylor Smart on the base paths. Lemurs are down by a run. It's 2-1 Wichita. Lewson peers over his shoulder. He throws home a breaking ball, and that one's bunted at. Bunted right back to Lewson. He'll grab it after a hop, but he throws it away. It goes over by the tarp for the Lemurs, and Smart's going to go over to third base. Geiger runs the ball down, and the Lemurs make an error there. It might be costly there. We'll have to wait and see as Matt Lewson is going to get the ball back and get back up on top of the hill. Taylor Smart on the play moves all the way up to third base. Leo Vargas reaches on the error by Lewson himself. Jace Ray coming up to the plate, so we move up to the top of the order. 2-1 lead for the Wingnuts, and they're threatening here right now. It was an opportunity for the Lemurs to get an easy out and have a runner at second base. Instead, it goes for naught, and the error is made, and now runners are at second and third with nobody out. Leo Vargas takes the pitch high and away. It's one ball and no strikes. That's the first error up on the board tonight for the Laredo Lemurs. Of course, they don't want to make any more than that. Lewson gets the sign. He works out of the stretch with runners at second and third. He fires home, and that is a fastball that's at the letters on the outside part of the plate. Lewson at home this year, he has put up an 0-2 record and a 4.73 ERA. He has started 7 games at home, so this one being his 8th. He's got a 2.93 against average here at this ballpark. Here's the 1-1. Curveball misses outside, and Phil Pohl hopping out to his left. I think he was crossed up on the pitch. I think he was looking for something else and ended up getting the curveball. Luckily, he did get the curveball because he was able to adjust to it. So now he's going to go out and talk things over with Lucen, and Ty Forney going to go out there, and he's going to join in on the conversation. The Lemurs, by the way, they're 9-12 when Lucen takes the hill. So they've won 9 games and have lost 12. 2-1 to the batter. The leadoff man, Jace Ray. Ray with a base hit back in the second inning. He earned a walk back in the first. He was left stranded at third base back in the first inning. And the 2-1 pitch. A fastball high. Making it 3-1. And now, Lucen in danger of walking. The base is loaded. Of course, I don't know if that would hurt him all that bad. At least it would set up a force. And the Lemurs would be able to relax the defense a little bit to try to go for the double play ball. Here comes the 3-1. That one is low and inside, ball four, so that's exactly what's going to happen. Jace Ray is going to earn his second walk of the night. David Espinoza is going to come up to the plate with the bases loaded. So things get deeper and deeper here for the Laredo Lemurs. And manager Pete Gavilla has seen enough. He's going to the bullpen right away. So he comes out of the dugout, takes about five steps out of the dugout, and he makes the sign down to the bullpen. So we're going to have a new pitcher coming in. The Lemurs are down 2-1. The bases are loaded for the Wingnuts as we sit in the top of the seventh inning. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball. We'll be right back with the new pitcher.
Sweating through another barn burner at your team's bar?
Sure am.
Wish you had some ice-cold refreshment?
You bet.
Then Coors Light may be right for you. Could result in meeting new people, epic fist bumps, epic forearm bumps, epic or chest bumps, touchdown dancing, break dancing, line dancing, dancing like nobody's watching, awesome refreshment, refreshment for the win, and one-of-a-kind Rocky Mountain cold refreshment. Ask your bartender for Coors Light today.
Definitely.
When cold refreshment calls, Coors Light answers. Frost-brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
Right now, you could be working towards an exciting new career in business administration. At Catholic College Laredo, you'll have the chance to gain professional skills and hands-on training. Earning a business degree could open the door to new career opportunities in fields such as accounting, human resources, banking, and marketing. Start on the path to your new career at Kaplan College. Call 800-617-0800. Right now, you could be working towards an exciting new career in business administration. At Kaplan College Laredo, you'll have the chance to gain professional skills and hands-on training. Earning a business degree could open the door to new career opportunities in fields such as accounting, human resources, banking, and marketing. Start on the path to your new career at Kaplan College. Call 800-617-0800.
Kaplan College does not guarantee employment or career advancement. Information about programs at www.kaplancollege.com/consumer-info.
Today at Whataburger, we're cooking the Honey Mustard Water Chicken Club. The chicken is hot and fresh. It's got melted Monterey Jack cheese topped with lettuce, tomato, bacon, and then the honey mustard adds a nice sweet flavor to it.
All the flavors come together just perfect. I mean, not only do I want to eat it, but I keep wanting to look at it.
The crunchiness of the bacon adds a really nice texture.
Honey mustard and chicken just go together. You know, sweet and savory, it's a perfect mix.
Try the new Honey Mustard Water Chicken Club.
Only at Whataburger for a limited time.
Looking to travel this summer? If the year-round flights to Las Vegas aren't fit for you, take advantage of Allegiant's direct flights from Laredo International Airport to Orlando. For as low as $119 round trip, you and your family can be in Orlando in 2.5 hours. Fly in comfort from your Laredo International Airport. Visit Allegiant.com for details and specials. So BJ Hyatt taking over on the mound now for the Laredo Lemurs. The bases are loaded for Wichita. Matt Luthen's night is done. As soon as we wrap up this inning, we can give you his line score. Because all those runners out there belong to him, so we want to wait to see how the inning works out. So the batter is going to be David Espinoza. Espinoza on the season with the Wichita Wingnuts. Batting .291 on the year, so he's having a good season for his club. He's got 31 RBIs on the year as well. He'll have a chance to come up to the plate here to try to do some damage against the Laredo Lemurs. There's nobody out. So the Wingnuts will have a couple of opportunities here to get the job done, and the Lemurs got to play some good defense. They do not want to let another run come in to score. They're already down by one. So a tough task ahead as it is with Tim Brown up on the mound. Here's the pitch. Taken for a strike on the outside part of the plate, so the Lemurs do turn it over to B.J. Hyatt, a very successful pitcher this year for Laredo. But he's got to work out of a deep hole right now for his buddy Matt Luthen. The ball's in a strike. Here's the kick and the throw home, and that one is swung and missed. Wow! That one hummed in there at 95 miles an hour, and Espinoza way behind the pitch. David Espinoza, by the way, with the bases loaded this year. He's got 5 RBIs and 6 at-bats. No balls and 2 strikes. Corners in. The middle infielder's back at double play depth, and now timeout's called. And David Espinoza batting .333 with the bases loaded. He's got a .284 batting average with runners in scoring position. 1-2. Hyatt throws, and that one's low. Make it a 2-2 count now to David Espinoza. Espinoza 0 for 3 in the game. He's got a couple of strikeouts. BJ Hyatt, a tall right-hander, looking to get a strikeout for the Laredo Lemurs. Hyatt sets high by the chest. He'll bring it home, and that one is called strike 3. Lemurs get exactly what they're looking for there. And that is the third time tonight that David Espinoza has gone down. Twice swinging, once looking. And that'll bring up TJ Mittelstadt. Mittelstadt also with a couple of strikeouts on the night. One looking, one swinging. Hyatt, by the way, here's his numbers. He's got a 2-0 record on the year and a .87 ERA, so an ERA under 1. And that's through 30 games, so he's been stellar for the Lemurs. Remember, Hyatt not too far removed from labrum surgery. Here's Mittelstadt. The pitch, a changeup, misses low. One ball and no strikes. Lemurs down by a run, but the Wingnuts with the bases loaded here in the seventh inning. We got deep into this ball game pretty quickly. Both Tim Brown and Matt Lucen each retired 10 in a row at one point. Here's the 1-0 pitch. Fastball swung on, lined into center field. It's going to drop for a hit. Coming in to score from third base is Taylor Smart. Going over to third base is Leo Vargas, and the ball from Devontre Richardson goes over everyone's head and into the dugout of the Wichita Wingnuts. That'll bring in another run. So an error by Richardson sends the runners moving up. So I'll have to break all this down for you. Smart scores on the base hit. Vargas scores on the error. Jace Ray all the way over to third base, and Mittelstadt's going to get the extra base due to the ball going into the dugout. So runners now at second and third for Wichita, and they have a 4-1 lead. So two errors here in the inning for the Laredo Lemurs. Only one RBI for Mittelstadt on the play. And here's the pitch to Andy LaRoche. LaRoche takes low. No balls and a strike. So BJ Hyatt still trying to preserve what he can here for the Laredo Lemurs. The 0-1 delivery swung on and tapped off the top of the plate. The ball's going to roll over to the right. So a foul ball there. So Jace Ray's over at third base. TJ Mittelstadt at second for Wichita. Leo Vargas comes in to score on the error by the center fielder. So one runner still out there. It does belong to Matt Lucen. That's Jace Ray. No balls and two strikes. One out. Infield playing in again for Laredo. Here's the pitch to LaRoche, and he swings. Hits one high and deep out to left field. Going back, and the ball is Morrison. He runs out of room. The ball is over the fence. A home run for Andy LaRoche. And that is going to put the Lemurs into a deep hole. It's going to be a 7-1 lead for the Wichita Wingnuts, and the former major leaguer comes here to Uni-Trade Stadium, and it's a home run. It looked like a regular pop-up to left field off of his bat. I don't even know if he got all of that one or not, but sure didn't look like it off of the bat. It just kept soaring out of the ballpark. So a home run up on the board for the Wingnuts, and they have scored 5 runs here on the here in the inning. Seven to one Wichita, and into the batter's box is Matt Pageant. One out. Here's the pitch by Hyatt. Hyatt throws a fastball there and misses low and inside. So that can wrap up the night on Matt Lucen now. One ball and no strikes to Pageant. And unfortunately, a lot of runs end up coming in to score, but some of them will be unearned due to the errors. The 1-0 pitch, a hard hit ground ball over to Geiger at first base. He'll bobble it a little bit, but he'll go over and touch the bag successfully. So a 3 unassisted, and that'll be the second out in the inning. John Nestor is going to be coming up to the plate. 7-1 Wichita. Nestor 0 for 3 in the game. So a couple of long balls given up tonight by the Lemurs. The Lemurs pitching staff, by the way, they have the lowest long ball ratio in the league. this season. So they've given up the least amount of home runs to other teams. And they've given up 29 now with the two here. That's a total of 31 home runs that they've given up through their 78 games played, including this one tonight. This one's being the 78th. Two outs. Here's the pitch. Changeup misses inside. So Nestor moves out of the way of that one. One ball and no strikes. And Hyatt works on the first base side of the rubber. Holds the baseball behind his back as he gets ready to throw to John Nestor. He still works out of the stretch with nobody on, and the pitch is low for a ball. So I'm thinking that's the first home run given up this year by B.J. Hyatt. We'll have to go into the archives here and take a look, but I'm pretty sure he hasn't given up a long ball. Oh, actually, that's his second. Okay. So his second home run that he's given up. So he's done very well for the Lemurs this year, and really just a slight bump on the road here. Two balls and no strikes. Here's the pitch. Swung in a liner. One hopped over to the second baseman, Taylor. Taylor will backhand. He'll set and throw over to first base, and it's in time to get the out. So finally, the inning comes to an end. But five runs come in to score for the Wichita Wingnuts. They get five runs on three hits. There were two errors and nobody left. Wow. We're going to go to the bottom of the seventh inning. It's 7-1 Wichita.
Miller invented light beer, the original light pilsner, and that changed everything. This led to fewer guys with beer bellies, which led to more women attracted to those guys, which led to dates, second dates, wedding bells, and honeymoons, which led to hubbada hubbada, boom, which led to you. Miller Lights, we invented light beer, and you, you're welcome. 12 ounces contain 96 calories, 3.2 carbs, 1 protein, 0 fat. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Texas Inflatable Rentals has Laredo's largest water slides. We are proud to say that we serve the greater Laredo area and supply slip sliding fun for kids of all ages. Texas Inflatable Rentals has a huge selection of inflatables for every budget. And to add to the party, we rent tables, chairs, snow cone machines, popcorn machines, and cotton candy machines that will help take your party to the next level. We also have moonwalks and bounce houses. Contact Texas Inflatable Rentals at 956-436-3909 or at texasinflatablerentals.com. And book with the coupon code LEMURS for a 10% discount. That's Texas Inflatable Reynolds, Laredo's largest water slide.
Driscoll Health Plan loads the bases with value. We knock it out of the park with all the value-added services we bring to our Medicaid members. Driscoll families cheer on the Grand Slam packages, sports physicals, free memberships to Boys and Girls Clubs, and dental care for pregnant women over 21. Take a swing at our baby showers offered by Cadena de Madre. Forget those peanuts and Cracker Jacks, root for our baby blankets and more. Come slide into home when you receive gift cards for completing Texas Health Steps checkups and attending postpartum visits on time. Don't miss a play. Restrictions and limits may apply. Visit DriscollHealthPlan.com.
All right, Dustin Geiger to lead it off for Laredo. They're down 7-1 here in the game. Here's the pitch, and that one's taken low for a ball. So back underway here at Uni-Trade Stadium, and now the Lemurs have a big hill to climb. And Tim Brown still working on the mound for Wichita. A line drive off the bat of Geiger into left field, a base hit. So that's a good way to start the comeback right there for the Laredo Lemurs. So the Lemurs trail by six. Each team with six hits, but a couple of errors have really hurt the Lemurs. So we'll go ahead and get to the scoreboard from around the American Association this half inning, bring you up to date on what's going on in the rest of the league. And into the box now is Phil Pohl. Runner at first base and nobody out. Pohl swings and hits one into center field. It's high in the air. Going back on the ball is Ray. He'll turn around and make the catch. So Phil Pohl sees one pitch and flies out to center field, and that'll bring up Juan Silverium. So here's the scoreboard from the AA. Fargo 8, Winnipeg 6. They're in the bottom of the 7th inning. In the bottom of the 8th inning, Gary's up 3-2 over Sioux Falls. Joplin's winning their ball game over St. Paul 3-0. They're in the bottom of the 7th inning. St. Paul probably working on a little bit of a hangover after winning the division last night. They clinched, even though they kind of backed into it. Not always the funnest way to do it, but they have such a big lead, they knew it was coming sooner or later. And as the first pitch to Silverio's in there for a strike, a fastball in the inside corner. Yeah, St. Paul saw Winnipeg lose in a day game, and that backed them into the division title. Here's the 0-1, swung on and fouled off again. St. Paul later in the day went on to lose to Sioux City. So they weren't on the field when they actually won the division, and they took a loss that night. But I'm sure they celebrated anyway. No balls and two strikes, and well, they should. They've put up one heck of a tremendous fight this year. They're a very good baseball team. So Silverio looking for his 0-2 pitch. Here it comes, and it's high and outside. Amarillo's up 5-1 over Grand Prairie. They're in the bottom of the seventh inning. The Rockland Boulders 3, the Lincoln Salt Dogs 2. That's in the top of the ninth inning. Rockland looking to make it 12 in a row. 12 wins is what they're looking for. 1-2 pitch, swung and a liner into left field, a base hit. Geiger's going to move it up to second base. Silverio will go up to first. The Lemurs have runners at first and second with one out. Ty Forney's the next batter. Kansas City 3, Sioux City 1. They're in the bottom of the eighth there. So there's your American Association scoreboard. Lemurs trail by 6 here at Unitrade Stadium. A 5-run fifth inning. Did I just say that? A 5-run seventh inning for the Wichita Wingnuts. And the pitch. Swung and a ground ball at the third baseline. Off the bat of Ty Forney. It goes foul. Yep, 7 runs on 6 hits for Wichita. 1 run on 7 hits and 2 errors tonight for the Laredo Lemurs. Matt Lucen's final line goes like this. No balls and a strike up the plate for Forney. Runners at first and second. The pitch is a strike. That was a changeup. So Lucen went 6 complete, gave up 4 hits, 5 runs. 4 of them were earned. He walked 5 and struck out 7. He looked so good up into that very last inning. The 0-2 pitch. That's called strike 3. Forney goes down looking. That'll create the second out. That's the 4th strikeout thrown up on the board tonight for Tim Brown. And we go up to the top of the order for Ty Morrison. Morrison's having a nice night. He's 2-for-3. Well, you know going into the game, when you're facing off against Tim Brown, that you have a tough customer ahead of you. He's put up an 8-2 record this year. He's always been tough on the Lemurs. And he throws here, and it's a changeup that hits the outside part of the plate for a strike. So he's dealing with that changeup right now. Tim Brown out of the stretch, peers in, gets the sign from John Nestor. And the pitch home on the 0-1. That one's in the dirt, blocked by Nestor. He does a nice job back there for Wichita. It's always fun watching the catchers. If you come to the ballpark and you want something to watch, take a look at the catcher. Always involved in every play. When they're back there blocking balls, it's very important that they do so, especially with runners on. They make it look so easy, but it's not. Here's the pitch. Swung on and a pop-up over on the left side. That's going to go ahead and get down, and it's going to be a foul ball. So Geiger's going to have to retreat back to second base. Juan Silverio's going to have to go back to first. And we'll do it all over again, this time with a 1-2 count. Morrison on the hunt for his 3rd hit of the ball game. So Brown's jersey flopping in the wind out there as he looks in to get the sign. And the 1-2 pitch. It's a fastball, misses inside for a ball. 2-2 now to Morrison. Geiger takes his lead from second base. Silverio off the bag from first. Nobody holding on either runner. And the 2-2 pitch, swung and a fly ball into left field. On the run, Harrison Kane towards the left field line. He'll dive for the ball, and it's going to be a foul ball, and it's going to be caught. An amazing catch, and is Harrison Kane okay? Yeah, he's up. He's coming in. He went out of our view here at Unitrade Stadium, and the umpire said he made the catch. And, man, he went diving head first towards the railing, and he comes up okay, and he comes up with the catch. Well, hats off to you, Harrison Kane. That was nicely done. Unfortunately for the Lemurs, they are out of the inning. No runs, two hits, no errors, and two left. We're going to the top of the eighth inning. The Lemurs are down 7-1.
You want to sit in a car for 7 hours, risk a flat tire, traffic, or highway construction delays? Fly direct from Laredo International Airport to Dallas-Fort Worth on American Airlines. From Dallas, you can change planes and take a flight to Tokyo, London, or even Rio de Janeiro. With four daily arrivals and departures, American Airlines is sure to have a connection that works best for you. So avoid spending hours in the car or risk an accident on the highway or even a flat tire. Fly in comfort from Laredo International Airport. Visit AA.com for details and to book a reservation.
Crowd at the bar making you sweat?
Uh-huh.
Could you use some ice-cold refreshment?
You bet.
Then Coors Light may be right for you. Could result in epic nights, maximum refreshment, great times, awesome memories, high fives, smiles, Rocky Mountain refreshment, Blue Mountain refreshment, quadruple epic refreshment, killer parties, and totally refreshed killer parties. Ask your bartender for Coors Light today.
Definitely.
When cold refreshment calls, Coors Light answers. Frost Brewed Coors Light, the world's most refreshing beer. Coors Brewing Company, Golden, Colorado. With great beer comes great responsibility.
This summer, Allegiant will increase to 4 weekly flights to Las Vegas, Nevada. If gambling in Vegas isn't your thing, Allegiant is also increasing to 2 weekly flights to Orlando. Enjoy the Disney theme parks, Legoland, Universal Studios, SeaWorld, and the Kennedy Space Center. Fly in comfort from your Laredo International Airport. Visit Allegiant.com for details and specials. Texas Outlaw Grill is a proud sponsor of your Laredo Lemurs, specializing in outlaw delicacies such as the Texican, the Gringo, and the Bandit Hot Dog and their ever-famous barbecue burger. Be the first to try their groundbreaking Cabarito Hamburger and Cabarito Hot Dog. For all to-go orders, catering, and fundraising information, go by 5209 Springfield Suite No. 4 or call 956-771-1919. That's Texas Outlaw Grill.
Laredo Sports Medicine Clinic, the official team doctors of your Laredo Lemurs. Now with two convenient locations to better serve you. Our north location is located at 9652 McPherson Road, Suite 12. Our south location is located at 5102 State Highway 359. Laredo Sports Medicine offers an array of services from physical therapy to our newest service, orthopedic surgery. Laredo Sports Medicine Clinic is changing orthopedic care one athlete at a time. Visit our website at laredosportsmed.com for more information.
So the man that makes the great catch going towards the left field line, Harrison Kane, is able to step up to the plate here, and he'll get the at-bat. So he gets the reward, making the nice catch, and you get the reward to come on up to the plate. You know, it just happens to be that his spot in the order is up. Willie Pareda is up on the mound. He'll take over for the Lemurs, for B.J. Hyde, and he'll throw a fastball that misses low. Lemurs down by six. It's a 7-1 ball game in favor of Wichita. And we're in the top of the eighth inning here at Uni-Trade Stadium. And the pitch from Willie Paredes, and a ground ball over to the shortstop, charging Ty Forney. Forney bobbles a little bit, throws on the run, and it's not going to be in time. It's going to be a base hit for Harrison Kane. So Kane with his second hit of the ball game. And Taylor Smart coming up to the plate. So tough play there for Ty Forney. Had to charge it really hard. Had to grab it with his bare hand and try to throw it strongly over to first base. And just wasn't in time. Harrison Kane has some speed as well. So here's Taylor Smart, another guy with some speed out there on the base pass. Smart picked up a double in his last at bat. So Willie Pareda is the right-hander up on the hill for the Laredo Lemurs. He throws home with a runner on base, and this one's grounded over to the second baseman, Taylor. Taylor will flip to Forney for one. Back over to first base. That's a double play. So a Taylor-made double play to Kevin Taylor. I don't know why I waited this long to pull that one out of my hat, but I finally was able to do it. Two down quickly. And Leo Vargas is the next batter. So where is Leo? There he is. He's still in the on-deck circle. Get on up there, Mr. Vargas. So Leo Vargas on the day. He has scored a run. He's the guy that reached on an error by Matt Lucen back in the seventh inning. That kind of opened up the door for all the scoring there in that inning. First pitch from Paredes is in there for a strike. And Vargas was the one that tried to lay down the bunt to sacrifice Taylor Smart over. Loosen grabbed the ball, threw it past the first baseman, Geiger, and then there was runners at first and second. The 0-1 pitch, high for a ball. Next thing you know, Jace Ray came up to the plate. He walked. That loaded the bases. A strikeout by David Espinoza after B.J. Hyatt was introduced. And then a single by T.J. Mittelstadt, which ended up having an error on it in the outfield. The 0-1-1 pitch swung on and grounded over to Kevin Taylor. Taylor will backhand this one. He'll straighten up and throw over to first base, and that's going to do it for the Wichita Wingnuts. They get a base hit, but after that, the double play ball, Dan Leo Vargas grounds out. We're going to head to the bottom of the eighth inning. The Lemurs are coming up to the plate. They need some runs. They're down 7-1.
Breakfast speaks for itself here at Whataburger. It's going to be hot. It's going to be fresh.
It's almost like when you were a kid and you wake up in the morning, you can smell mom cooking breakfast.
I like their hash browns.
My favorite is the honey butter chicken biscuit. I like the taquitos.
We have some fresh cracked eggs here.
I like these pancakes because they're fluffy.
I really like the fact that you can get into Whataburger real fast and bring it on the go.
We're cooking breakfast for you at Whataburger.
Welcome to Whataburger. Today we're cooking the sweet and spicy bacon burger.
Wow, it's beautiful.
Two beef patties, American cheese, Monterey Jack cheese, bacon, grilled onions, the sweet and spicy pepper sauce.
Sweet in the front and then the spicy in the back. I like it. I like it a lot.
So it's like a perfect balance, and then that bacon right there, it adds crunchiness.
I'd get back in line and get another one, I'll tell you that much.
Sweet spicy bacon burger. Come down to Whataburger. It's only here for a limited time.
There's a reason why Popeyes creates some of the best tasting chicken in the world. We were born in New Orleans, Louisiana, the land of good fun and great cooking. Spicy flavor is a way of life in New Orleans, and everything we make reflects it. From our Popeyes bona fide chicken and handcrafted tenders, to our home-style mashed potatoes with Cajun gravy and our soft, buttery biscuits, everything we make is made with care and served up fresh. Only at Popeyes.
All right, Jeudy Valdez leading things off for the Lemurs. Tim Brown back up on the mound, so he's going to work here into the bottom of the eighth inning as he throws, and it misses high for a ball. Time to take a look around the big league, see if we can get some scores from around Major League Baseball to you at home. And Brown will fire again on the 1-0 pitch, swung it in a ground ball over to the shortstop. In front of it, Taylor Smart. He'll gobble it up and throw it over to first base for the out. That guy's got such a smooth glove over there. He does a nice job when he plays short or third. He's always been impressive ever since I've been watching him play. Kevin Taylor, the next batter for the Lemurs. Taylor looking to keep his hit streak alive. He's on a 12-game hitting streak. He needs a base hit to keep it alive here tonight. So Oakland and Baltimore, they're in the 10th inning. They're knotted up at 6 apiece. They're playing in Baltimore tonight. First pitch to Taylor is fouled back into the screen. Boston big over Seattle. They're up 15-1 in the top of the 9th inning. So the Red Sox pouring on the runs. Tampa Bay and Texas, they're knotted up at 3 apiece in the top of the 8th. The 0-1 pitch. Breaking ball misses away to Taylor. Houston 4, Tigers 1. They're in the top of the 7th inning. Royals are playing the Angels right now. And the 1-1 pitch. Swung on and fouled away off to the left. These two teams, the Royals and the Angels, they have some history. They like to brawl a little bit. So there might be some fisticuffs over the weekend here with the Angels and the Royals. We'll have to watch out for that. Royals are up right now 3-1 over the Angels. They're in the top of the 8th inning. The 1-2 pitch in the dirt. Milwaukee leading Philadelphia 3-0. They're in the top of the 9th inning. Cardinals 3, Marlins 1, top of the 9th. And going to the 7th inning, the Padres and the Rockies are tied up at 4 apiece. Here's the pitch to Taylor. He takes high for a ball. One of the late games, the Dodgers and the Reds playing ball out in Los Angeles. Reds 1, Dodgers 1. And it's 3-2 to Taylor. Here's the pitch. A swing and a ground ball down the third base line. That's going to be a base hit for Taylor. He's now hitting 13 straight. Keep it alive, Kevin Taylor. So Dennis Phipps coming up to the plate now for the Laredo Lemurs. One out in the inning. Phipps with a chance to do some damage. Lemurs are down 7-1 in the bottom of the 8th inning. The Giants and the Nationals playing ball out in San Francisco. It's a 1-1 tie. They're just underway. They're in the top of the 2nd inning. Cubbies win today. They beat the Chicago White Sox 6-5. Here's Phipps into the batter's box. The big righty. And he sees a changeup. It misses high. Ooh, the Yankees played the Toronto Blue Jays today, and they're playing in Toronto this time around. And boy, I'm anxious to see this series. The Yankees end up winning tonight 4-3. The 0-2 pitch to Phipps. He takes a long swing and a miss. Pirates beat the Mets 3-2. And the Arizona Diamondbacks and the Atlanta Braves are all done. The Braves win 3-2. So Phipps awaits his next pitch. Here it comes. And there it goes. A liner into right field. A base hit just by the glove of the second baseman, Vargas. Vargas was ranging for it to his left. He had his mitt fully extended but could not come up with the baseball. So back-to-back hits for the Lemurs. And we'll see how long Tim Brown stays in this ballgame. He has a plenty big cushion right now. They're up by 6 of the Wingnuts. Here comes Devontre Richardson. And your final score of the night, Cleveland 6, Minnesota 1. There you have the big league scoreboard. We'll check in the news, see if anything big's going on throughout Major League Baseball as Richardson takes the first pitch for a strike. Well, Miguel Cabrera, he was activated from the disabled list for the Tigers. That's some news. No balls and a strike. And the delivery to Richardson. He lines it into center field. Hustling in is Ray. Ray will make a head first dive. And he made the catch. It'd be nice if one of the umpires showed us that he made the catch, but no one moved, so I'm guessing he made the catch. I love it when an umpire puts his arm up and says, out. So I know for sure that it was an out. I had to guess because I didn't see the runners moving. I'm guessing it was an out. You know, it's a small gesture by the umpires to raise the arm and let everybody know that he is out. All right, enough beating up the umpires. Geiger into the batter's box. And he swings at the first pitch, lines it right to the third baseman. And there is an umpire raising his arm. It's the home plate umpire, and he says, out. So that one lined right at the third baseman. Making the catch was LaRoche, the former major leaguer. And that's going to do it for the Lemurs. No runs, two hits, no errors, and two left. We are going to go to the top of the ninth inning. The Lemurs trail 7-1 here at Uni-Trade Stadium.
Falcon Bank and the Laredo Lemurs are a winning combination. At Falcon, they know what counts. Personalized service, attention to detail, and genuine commitment to helping customers achieve their dreams. Falcon Bank, guided by faith, grounded by family, and committed to you.
Need a little spark in your life? Then come on out to Uni-Trade Stadium for Friday Night Fireworks. Tickets start as low as $5, and you'll get to see great baseball and great fireworks all in one night. To get tickets, call 956-7-LEMURS or go online at laredolemurs.com. I'll see you at the ballpark. Hey, Lemurs fans, every Thursday night at Uni-Trade Stadium is a Thirsty Thursday. Come on out and enjoy cold Miller Lite draft beers for only $1. That's right, beer for a buck. You can get tickets online at laredolemurs.com or by phone at 956-7-LEMURS. I'll see you at the ballpark.
Unitrade continues to provide solutions in foreign trade through a highly satisfactory customs brokerage service. Unitrade has quality trained personnel devoted to the highest level of customer service. For all your transportation, distribution, and consolidation needs, it's Unitrade. Chavarrias Plumbing's the number one choice for any plumbing problem. Chavarrias is a full-service company with up-to-date technology trained professionals. With over 30 years of service to the community, Chavarrias is still growing strong. Visit chavarriasplumbing.com. And go Lemurs!
Core Business Solutions is a proud sponsor of Lemurs Baseball. Core Business Solutions services the 17 southernmost counties of Texas as well as areas of northern Mexico. They offer a wide range of high-tech solutions for businesses and organizations. Make Core Business Solutions your solution today. For all of your vehicle collision repair and paint needs, there's only one place to turn: Mike's Paint Place. Mike's Paint Place has computerized color matching and digital imaging. They also do full frame and suspension repairs. Stop by and see Mike's Paint Place today at 6410 Polaris Drive in Laredo.
Tokyo Garden of Laredo is located at 2515 East Del Mar Boulevard, and they serve the best sushi in town. Stop by Tokyo Garden for a quick lunch or a fancy dinner. Either way, you're going to enjoy our fine cuisine. Did you just get off work? Then come on by and check out our happy hour specials. Tokyo Garden, where you'll find the best sushi in Laredo.
Right now, when you sign up for a Gold's Gym membership, you'll get tons of extras completely free. Confidence, free. Compliments from your coworkers, free. and the desire to wear tiny bathing suits, you guessed it, free. You'll be stronger with extras, and you'll be stronger with Gold's Gym. Know your own strength. Tiny bathing suit not included.
Pro Mega Signs of Laredo is there for all of your printing and signage needs. We can be found at 1615 Jackman Road in Laredo, or you can reach us by phone at 956-723-2110. Again, that's 956-723-2110. If you need a sign, big or small, come to Pro Mega Signs of Laredo, where your print job is just around the corner.
All right, here we go into the top of the ninth inning. Luis De La Cruz taking over on the mound now for the Laredo Lemurs. The Lemurs trail 7-1. And the top of the order is coming up. It's going to be Jace Ray, followed by David Espinosa, and then TJ Mittelstadt coming up to the plate. 7 runs on 7 hits for Wichita, 1 run on 9 hits for the Lemurs. The Lemurs have made 2 errors, though, and Tim Brown has worked himself out of trouble quite a bit. The only run he's given up to Laredo was a home run by Dennis Phipps. Even though the Lemurs do have 9 hits in the ballgame, they've out-hit Wichita, but they have not been able to bring the runs home. Lemurs left the bases loaded back in the third inning. They left 2 on back in the 7th. Here's the pitch, and that one is outside for a ball to the leadoff man, Jace Ray. Of course, a big 5-run 7th inning for Wichita is the difference in the game right now. Well, the Wingnuts still would be up 2-1 if they did not score all those runs there in the 7th inning. So, still a difference, but a bigger difference. Here's a ground ball, hard hit over to the right side. Kevin Taylor's up with it. He fires over to first base and gets the out. So Jace Ray retired and one down, and David Espinosa coming up to the plate. So Luis De La Cruz up on the mound. He's 1-2 on the season with a 3.72 ERA through 19 games. So today's his 20th ball game. It's almost like his 20th birthday. Happy 20th game to you, Luis De La Cruz. That didn't make any sense, huh? Yeah. It's not quite as fun as happy birthday. Happy 20th. Nah, it doesn't have the same impact. De La Cruz has thrown in 19 and a third innings, striking out 20 batters, giving up 10 walks, and giving up 16 hits. Here is the pitch to Espinosa. Espinosa takes low. And De La Cruz last pitched on August 11th against Amarillo. That was the very first game against the Thunderheads. First game of the homestand here at Uni-Trade Stadium. 1 ball and no strikes. The pitch. Swung and missed. Strike 1. I'm so glad we have a nice name for our ballpark. Uni-Trade Stadium. It just kind of rolls off the tongue really, really nicely. You got some of these ballparks and you're like, how do you say that? Why would you want to say that over and over and over again? Like last year in Amarillo. Man, Amarillo National Bank Sox Stadium. Awful. The 1-1 pitch. Call the strike on the outside part of the plate. Has to be the longest name ever for a stadium. It's no longer called that. They've moved just to simply Thunderhead Stadium this year because they changed the team name. They have some new management in there. 1 ball and 2 strikes, the pitch, and that one is high. I'm sure if Amarillo National Bank still wanted to sponsor them that they would still call it the Amarillo National Bank Sox Stadium, but they don't, and I'm happy for that. I'm actually glad they lost that sponsorship up in Amarillo. Sorry, Amarillo, but, you know, I got to think of myself when I'm in your ballpark. Here's the 2-2 pitch. Swung on and missed. There's strike 3. So back-to-back batters retired here. And David Espinosa having a rough night. That is his 4th strikeout of the evening. Well, he is wearing the golden sombrero as he heads back into the dugout. We learned earlier this year when we saw one of the batters. I could run it down for us real quick. Run down his name anyway. But somebody struck out 5 times against the Lemurs earlier this season. Who was that? Yeah, Joe Rapp from Kansas City struck out 5 times, and we found out with his 5 strikeouts that the 5th strikeout in a game is called the Platinum Sombrero. I didn't think I'd ever have to find that out, but I did. Here's the first pitch to TJ Mittelstadt. That's taken for a strike on the outside part of the plate. Lemurs trail by 6. We're in the 9th inning. Having a little fun up here in the press box, trying to keep you entertained back at home. Or maybe just trying to keep ourselves entertained up here in the press box. The 0-1 pitch. There's a strike on the outside part of the plate. A breaking ball from De La Cruz. So nonetheless, a good time here. 100-game season, you got to keep yourself entertained every now and then. No balls and 2 strikes. Lemurs play, of course, 50 here at Unitrade. 50 on the road. The 0-2 is in the dirt. Making a count of 1 ball and 2 strikes. The Lemurs in the bottom half of the inning, when they come up to the plate, it's going to be Pohl, Silverio, and Forney. So it's going to end up being 7-8-9 in the batting order against what might be Tim Brown. We'll have to wait and see if Tim Brown comes out. Brown, by the way, has thrown 99 pitches on the night. De La Cruz is going to throw number 11 right here. There it is, and it misses inside, a ball. So a fastball that was just above the belt, but I missed inside just a little bit. Two balls and two strikes to the batter, T.J. Mittelstadt. Mittelstadt with a couple of strikeouts here this evening, but not in danger of the sombrero. The 2-2 swung on and fouled into the ground. So we'll see another 2-2 pitch. So Mittelstadt's going to back out of the batter's box. He'll tighten up his batting gloves and get ready for the next pitch. So De La Cruz looking in. He's working out of the stretch. He's getting the sign from Phil Pohl. Pohl's done a nice job for the Lemurs tonight in his first effort behind the plate. The 2-2 pitch, called strike three. That'll do it for Mittelstadt. De La Cruz claps his hands with his mitt on one hand and his regular hand on the other. 7-1, Wichita. We're going to go ahead and go to the bottom of the ninth inning. The Lemurs need some runs. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball.
We all know we can accomplish more when we're ready. That's why I've chosen Texas A&M International University. I want a four-year degree and the opportunities that it brings. TAMU has welcomed me and more than 7,000 students from around the world. TAMU empowers me to greatness, ignites my mind, and propels me to my future and my impact. Imagine the possibilities when you're powered by TAMU.
Register now for summer and fall. Visit TAMU.edu and get powered.
Since Ascending Technologies opened for business in 1998, they have worked to establish solid relationships with their clients. They are set to maintain the highest standards of service and integrity and to perform work of only the highest quality, achieving client satisfaction on every project. They have attained these goals through a tradition of care and professional pride. They serve a wide range of corporations and small business franchises. Ascending Technologies has the tools and expertise for any technical need that your business may have. Call us here in Laredo at 725-2654. That's 725-2654 for Ascending Technologies.
Todos sabemos que podemos lograr más cuando estamos listos. Por eso, decidí matricularme en Texas A&M International University. Quiero un título universitario y las oportunidades que me brindará. TAMU me ha recibido a mí y a 7,000 estudiantes de todo el mundo. TAMU me impulsa a ser grande, enciende mi mente y hace mi corazón latir. Imagina las posibilidades cuando eres impulsado por TAMU.
Inscríbete ahora para verano y otoño. Visita tamu.edu y sé impulsado.
Capital Care EMS, located at 1510 Kaila Norte, Suite Number 11, invites you to experience a new standard in medical transportation. Servicing Laredo and all surrounding areas, Capital Care EMS provides transports to wound care treatments, HBO treatments, dialysis treatments, doctor's appointments, radiation treatments, chemotherapy treatments, and many more. From emergency medical transports to x-rays and lab work, our state-certified EMTs and paramedics are readily available 24 hours a day when you need them most. Capital Care EMS accepts most major medical insurances, including Medicare, Medicaid, Blue Cross Blue Shield, Aetna, and many more. Capital Care EMS is locally owned and operated. Call now for your free consultation. 956-712-8911. That's 956-712-8911. Capital Care EMS, creating a new standard in medical transportation. Capital Care EMS, the official ambulance of your Laredo Lemurs.
All right, back to action here at Uni-Trade Stadium. Bill Harrington with you, and first batter for the Laredo Lemurs is Phil Pohl, a new pitcher up on the mound for the Wichita Wingnuts. So Tim Brown's night is done. Taking the mound is Brad Orsi. He'll rock and fire again, and that pitch is in there for a strike. So Brown ends up going eight innings here tonight, and he was very, very fine up there on the hill. Lemurs down 7-1. Here's the kick and the throw home, and that one is swung and missed. Orsi has a very weird delivery. He's got a weird sidekick. He kind of brings the ball at three quarters of an angle. So we'll watch him throw again, kind of see if we can break this down for you. He throws, and that one swung on and missed. Wow. Don't really know how to define it. It's weird, though, I'll tell you that much. Usually you don't see a guy throw like this. Instead of kicking his leg up, he kicks it out to the side. Kind of like a can-can girl. Just kidding about the can-can girl part. But he actually kicks it out to the side, and then he brings his arm back and then thrusts it forward. If you're watching it there on the video screen, you can see it. Here's Juan Silverio. The pitch. That one's taken for a strike on the inside part of the plate. We're in the bottom of the ninth inning, so this is the last chance for the Lemurs. Silverio with a couple of hits tonight. And I have the line score for you from Tim Brown. I'll give you that. Here's the 0-1 delivery. Swung on and fouled away. So Brown ends the night going eight innings, giving up nine hits, one run. He walked a batter and struck out four. So another good night for Tim Brown against the Laredo Lemurs. And Brad Orsi, I believe he's a new player here with the Wichita Wingnuts. I do not recognize that name whatsoever. And I don't recognize it from anywhere in the American Association. Next pitch to Silverio misses. So one ball and two strikes to Silverio. See if we can look up any information on Brad Orsi real quick for you. Always fun to find out about the new guys in the league. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Swung on, popped up on the infield. Who's going to take this one? Smart's going to go and take it. He's the shortstop right in the middle of the infield dirt. He'll make the catch. So two down and Ty Forney scheduled to hit. And that is Ty Forney coming up to the plate. So Forney coming up for his fourth at bat of the night. He did lay down a sack bunt earlier in the night, so that at bat does not count against his stats on the day. So officially 0 for 2. And the throw home is taken high for a ball, a fastball in there at 90 miles an hour. So here's a little bit about Orsi. He was never drafted, played at Texas Lutheran University. And he kicks and throws home on the 1-0, a swing and a miss by Ty Forney. He has played professionally in the independent ranks, played in the Pecos League, has played in the United League. He's played a little bit in the American Association last year, but only for three games. He played for the Normal Corn Belters earlier this year as Forney swings and fouls the next pitch off. So overall, Brad Orsi is 13-10 in his career with a 4.78 ERA. And he has started some games. In fact, he's worked primarily as a starter in his career, but it looks like they're going to try to switch him to a reliever with the Wichita Wingnuts. He has pitched in 37 games altogether and has made 34 total starts. The 1-2, that one is way outside. In fact, it goes all the way back to the screen. And the Pecos League, he played for the Alpine Cowboys in Alpine, Texas. Played for the Rio Grande Valley White Wings in the United League. And he spent a short time with the Fargo Moorhead Redhawks. Back in 2014, he played three games there. And like I said, earlier this year with the Normal Corn Belters, only three games there. Here's a soft pop-up into shallow left field, going out the third baseman, LaRoche. LaRoche will squeeze it, and that's going to be the ball game. The Lemurs lose tonight by a final score of 7-1 in the opening of this three-game series. We're going to take a timeout. We'll come back with a post-game show. You're listening to Laredo Lemurs Baseball. Stay tuned.
Thanks for joining us for Laredo Lemurs Baseball, brought to you by Popeye's Chicken, AEP Texas, Armadillo Homes, Ascending Technologies, Ashley's Furniture of Laredo, Capital Care EMS, Chavarrias Plumbing, Core Business Solutions, Driscoll Health Plan, Falcon International Bank, Family Chevrolet, Gold's Gym, Getter Communications, HEB, iGadget Repair Center, Kaplan College, Laredo International Airport, Laredo Pony League, Laredo Sports Medicine, Mike's Paint Place, Pepsi, Pro Mega Signs, Southern Distributing, Southern Sanitation, Talk and Talk Wireless, TAMU Housing and Residence, Texas Farm Bureau, Texas Inflatables, Texas Outlaw Grill, Tokyo Garden, Total Termite Pest and Control, Uni-Trade 40, Whataburger of Alice. The Laredo Lemurs post-game show is coming your way next.
Capital Care EMS, located at 1510 Calle Norte, Suite Number 11, invites you to experience a new standard in medical transportation. Servicing Laredo and all surrounding areas, Capital Care EMS provides transports to wound care treatments, HBO treatments, dialysis treatments, doctor's appointments, radiation treatments, chemotherapy treatments, and many more. From emergency medical transports to x-rays and lab work, our state-certified EMTs and paramedics are readily available 24 hours a day when you need them most. Capital Care EMS accepts most major medical insurances, including Medicare, Medicaid, Blue Cross Blue Shield, Aetna, and many more. Capital Care EMS is locally owned and operated. Call now for your free consultation. 956-712-8911. That's 956-712-8911. Capital Care EMS, creating a new standard in medical transportation. Capital Care EMS, the official ambulance of your Laredo Lemurs.
Miller invented light beer, the original light pilsner, and that changed everything. This led to people wondering, L-I-T-E? That's how you spell light? Which led to people thumbing through their dictionaries. Which led to, there's gotta be a better way to look up words. Which led to the invention of spell check. Which led to better resumes, promotions, celebrations, and happy hour. Miller Lite, we invented light beer and happy hour. You're welcome. 12 ounces contain 96 calories, 3.2 carbs, 1 protein, 0 fat. Great beer, great responsibility. Miller Brewing Company, Milwaukee, Wisconsin.
Hey, ¿tienes algo que celebrar? ¿Que le salió el primer diente a tu hijo? ¿Que tu abuelita aprendió a tuitear? ¿Que cambiaste tu cheque? La respuesta es la misma. Pues un carnesazo. No importa lo que estés celebrando, lo que importa es que lo celebres. Pues con un carnesazo de HEB. En HEB encuentras gran variedad de cortes a precios bajos y de buena calidad. Carnesazo. Carne asada con ganas. Solo en HEB.
South Texas families never strike out with Driscoll Health Plan. Catch the value-added services we pitch to our Medicaid members. Enjoy a free membership to specific Boys and Girls Clubs. Receive gift cards for completing Texas healthcare checkups. Restrictions and limitations may apply. Visit us at DriscollHealthPlan.com.
Before your Memorial Day party gets going, drive over to Ashley Furniture Home Store this week for our best Memorial Day sale ever. Get dramatic price reductions store-wide or no interest until January 2021. Choose from sofas and sectionals all at unbelievably low prices. Plus, find savings on beds and amazing deals on dining rooms. It's our best Memorial Day sale ever, so don't wait. Hurry over to Ashley Furniture Home Store right now. Ashley Furniture Home Store. This is home. 4520 San Bernardo Avenue, Laredo, Texas. 956-712-2401. Subject to credit approval. Minimum monthly payments required. See store for details.
3, 2, 1, number one. That's Laredo's number one Chevy dealer. Family Chevrolet turns the best day ever into the best month ever. 15% off, not good enough, but 25% off, now that makes it the best month ever. With over 600 vehicles available, makes it the best pricing ever. 2015 Equinox, 2015 Traverse, not 15, but 25% off. And the best financing rates for the best month ever, 1.9 interest. Family Chevrolet of Laredo.com. Come see why the deals are always better at Family Chevrolet. Family Chevrolet is the number one volume Chevy dealer for a reason. Every customer rides during our spring cleaning closeout sale with massive price cuts on 600 Chevys. New 2015 Chevy Cruze. How about 25% off MSRP? Wow, that's huge. Or only $199 a month. New 2015 Malibu for only $269 a month. Or 25% off MSRP. Plus 2 years free maintenance and a 100,000-mile warranty. It's a spring cleaning closeout sale happening now at the number one volume Chevy dealer. Come see why the deals are always better at Family Chevrolet.
Now it's time for the Laredo Lemurs post-game show. Laredo Lemurs Baseball is brought to you by Popeye's Chicken, AEP Texas, Armadillo Homes, Ascending Technologies, Ashley's Furniture of Laredo, Capital Care EMS, Chavarias Plumbing, Core Business Solutions, Driscoll Health Plan, Falcon International Bank, Family Chevrolet, Gold's Gym, Guerra Communications, HEB, iGadget Repair Center, Kaplan College, Laredo International Airport, Laredo Pony League, Laredo Sports Medicine, Mike's Paint Place, Pepsi, Pro Mega Signs, Southern Distributing, Southern Sanitation, Talk and Talk Wireless, TAMU Housing and Residence, Texas Farm Bureau, Texas Inflatables, Texas Outlaw Grill, Tokyo Garden, Total Termite Pest and Control, Uni-Trade Boarding, Whataburger of Alice. Now here's Bill Harrington with Laredo Lemurs post-game show.
All right, Lemurs fans, thanks for sticking around for the post-game show here at Uni-Trade Stadium. We got some fireworks going off in the background, so if you hearing some popping and some booming and some banging, that's what it is. It's the fireworks show that we have here at the ballpark tonight. So if you're in town on a Friday, we're going to have, well, no, this is actually our last fireworks show of the year. Look at that. So if the Lemurs make the playoffs and they play on a Friday, then come on out to the ballpark. We will have a lot of fun. So here's your line score for the ball game tonight. The Wichita Wingnuts pick up 7 runs on 7 hits. They made no errors. They left 5 runners on. The Lemurs have one run on 9 hits. They made 2 errors tonight, and they left 8 runners on. The winning pitcher tonight was Tim Brown. He goes 8 innings, gives up 9 hits, 1 run. It was earned. He walked a batter and struck out 4. The only run he gave up was a solo home run to Dennis Phipps. Phipps hit it over the left center field. Well, it was Dennis's 10th home run of the season for the Laredo Lemurs. Losing pitcher was Matt Lucen. Lucen goes 6 innings, gives up 4 hits, 5 runs. 4 of them were earned. He walked 5 and struck out 7. BJ Hyatt also pitched, so did Willie Paredes, and Luis De La Cruz also saw time on the mound tonight for Laredo. So this is how the game went for the Laredo Lemurs. The Lemurs saw the Wingnuts score in the top of the second inning. A leadoff walk to Matt Pagen in the top of the second. It was the second walk thrown up there by Matt Lucen. Then John Nestor flew out to left field. And then Harrison Kane, a former Lemur, popped one over the left field wall for a home run. And that put the Wichita Wingnuts up 2-0. In the bottom of the second inning, Dennis Phipps came up to the plate. That's when he hit his 10th home run of the year, making it a 2-1 ball game. And then Matt Lucen would go on and pitch very well after he got his last out in the third inning. In fact, he went on to retire 10 straight batters, and then he gave up a base hit to the first batter that he saw in the seventh inning. So Taylor Smart reached base on a hit. Then Leo Vargas came up to the plate. Leo Vargas tried to lay down a bunt, and instead of, well, he did get the bunt down successfully, but the pitcher, Matt Lucen, grabbed the ball, threw it past the first baseman, Geiger, and that allowed the runners to be safe at each bag. So runners were at first and second base at the time. And the next batter, Jace Ray, came up to the plate. He would walk. That would load the bases. And actually, Smart and Vargas both moved up to second and third. So they're at second and third, and then Jace Ray would earn the walk to load the bases. David Espinoza would then come up to the plate with the bases loaded. And a new pitcher would come in for the Laredo Lemurs. B.J. Hyatt would take over for Lucen. So Lucen would be done there in the seventh inning without getting an out. So Hyatt would strike out the first batter he saw, David Espinoza. And then T.J. Mittelstadt picked up a single. He lined the ball sharply into center field. Richardson came on quickly, got to the ball. One run was already in to score. Richardson threw the ball to third base, trying to get the runner Leo Vargas out. Well, the ball was overthrown. It went into the stands, and that allowed another run to come in to score. So at the time, it was 4-1 Wichita. And the Lemurs would see Andy LaRoche come up to the plate, the former major leaguer. And with two runners on, he would hit a home run over the left field wall. And that would really put the game out of place for the Laredo Lemurs. It ended up being 7-1 at the time. And no other runs would score in the ball game here at the ballpark tonight. So the Lemurs take a loss tonight. The game was played in 2 hours and 32 minutes in front of a crowd of 2,041 people here at the ballpark tonight. So let's quickly take a look at the scoreboard. Let you know how everybody else did in the American Association. But their main opponent is right in front of them here at Uni-Trade Stadium tonight. The Wichita Wingnuts are the guys that the Lemurs want to go out and beat, and so they could try to gain some ground in the South Division. But unfortunately, they'll fall another game back in the South tonight after their loss this evening. So here's the scoreboard. Fargo and Winnipeg still playing ball. They're in the bottom of the eighth inning. Fargo's taking the lead. They're up 8-7 in that one. Joplin beat St. Paul tonight, a 3-1 final. So that'll keep them in the same place that they're at. We'll tell you about that here as soon as we get to the standings portion of the post-game show. Sioux City 5, Kansas City 3. That's a final. Amarillo beats Grand Prairie tonight, 6-1. Gary over the Sioux Falls Canaries, a 6-2 final. And the Lincoln Salt Dogs beat the Rockland Boulders 4-3. And, of course, you know the final score here. Wichita 7, Laredo 1. So we'll go ahead and take a look at the standings. Let you know how those all break down. And the computer going a little bit slower here tonight at Uni-Trade Stadium. I think all the fireworks may be thrown off the internet. I don't know. That might be it. Well, with the Lemurs' loss, I know they're going to be 6 games back behind the Wichita Wingnuts as the night comes to an end. But I want to give you all the standings here. Well, the computer's not going to play with me here tonight, so the Joplin Blasters, they win. They're going to stay 4 games back. The Lemurs are going to move 6 games back, and that'll probably be enough to get you through for the night, I'm sure, because we're not going to be able to take a look at the standings here. Oh, finally they're popping up. There we go. So with everything in the books, Wichita now has won 4 straight. The Joplin Blasters, like I said, they stay 4 back. The Lemurs are now 6 back in the South Division, so they got a little bit of a deeper hole to climb out of if they want to try to win the South Division. The wild card race looks like this. The Joplin Blasters lead the wild card race. They're at 42-34. Kansas City is right behind them at 41 and 34, and the Lemurs are at 41 and 37. So although Kansas City and Laredo have the same number of wins, the Kansas City T-Bones have less losses. So that gives them a higher winning percentage of 547, and the Lemurs' winning percentage is 526. So the Lemurs currently in third place for that wild card standing right now. So they're having the explosiatorium here right now. The finale is going on at the ballpark. So we're going to go ahead and call it a night. That's a taking a quick look at the scoreboard and the standings, and we'll be back at it tomorrow night. 7:15 for the pregame, 7:30 for the first pitch here at Uni-Trade Stadium. Hope you all have a good night, and we'll see you tomorrow night for the pregame show at 7:15. Have a good night, everybody.
Thanks for joining us for Laredo Lemurs Baseball, brought to you by Popeye's Chicken, AEP Texas, Armadillo Homes, Ascending Technologies, Ashley's Furniture of Laredo, Capital Care EMS, Chavarrias Plumbing, Core Business Solutions, Driscoll Health Plan, Falcon International Bank, Family Chevrolet, Gold's Gym, Getter Communications, HEB, iGadget Repair Center, Kaplan College, Laredo International Airport, Laredo Pony League, Laredo Sports Medicine, Mike's Paint Place, Pepsi, Pro Mega Signs, Southern Distributing, Southern Sanitation, Talk and Talk Wireless, TAMU Housing and Residence, Texas Farm Bureau, Texas Inflatables, Texas Outlaw Grill, Tokyo Garden, Total Termite Pest and Control, Uni-Trade Forwarding, Whataburger of Alice. Join us next time for all your Laredo Lemurs action.